says he recommended leaving at least 2,500 U.S. personnel in Afghanistan, but only until certain diplomatic conditions were met.
The fundamental tension facing the president, in fact, two presidents, was that no one could satisfactorily explain when or even if those conditions would ever be met. And if we stayed indefinitely, an open war would likely begin with the Taliban again, with increased risk of additional casualties.
President Biden has argued his choices were limited under a Trump administration deal with the Taliban. On day 11 of the search for a missing University of Missouri student in Tennessee, his family plans a news conference. Search crews have looked on land and in the Cumberland River, where Riley Strain's bank card was found on an embankment. America is listening to Fox News.
WIPC Mobile News, on the level, on the go.
A long day in court, sunny at 49 degrees in downtown Indianapolis. All clear on your radar with low temps dropping to about 38 tonight. I'm Harrison Silcox. Here's what's trending at 3:02. Judge Fran Gall decided to add two murder charges against Richard Allen in the Delphi murders case, but that wasn't all that was discussed at a hearing from yesterday. John Herrick explains.
The biggest issue of the morning half of Monday's hearing was the leak of crime scene pictures that were taken by a consultant working for Andy Baldwin, who's one of Allen's attorneys. The defense argued that the leak was an accident and that the person shared the pictures without Baldwin's knowledge. But the prosecutors claim that it was an ongoing leak because Baldwin was giving that case information to that consultant for a while. With Allen accused of killing Abby Williams and Libby German in Delphi back in 2017, the trial is supposed to begin in mid-May. John Herrick, 93, WIBC Mobile News.
A former corrections officer from Henry County was fired and is facing charges for shooting an inmate with a pepper ball, says Henry County Sheriff John Sproles.
I went ahead and terminated him the next morning. When I reviewed the camera and was talking to my chief deputy, I said, just right off the bat, I can't deal with that type of language. Obviously, the deploying the pepper ball around was under investigation.
Sproles says Curtis Dowdy has a trial that's scheduled for July. You should be prepped with proper pupil protection for the solar eclipse April 8th.
But these are glasses that would have to be worn 100% of the time during the solar eclipse if they're going to be looking directly at the sun.
Dr. Sarah Olvey with Peyton Manning Children's Carmel Pediatrics says the glasses need to have ISO certification. The Carb Day lineup has been announced. Here's Sam Fritz.
Carb Day fans this year will be treated to one bourbon, one scotch, one beer, and a performance from George Thurgood and the Destroyers. He was announced on Tuesday as the headliner for the 2024 Carb Day concert, along with opening act support from 90s rockers, the Gin Blossoms. Tickets start at $45 and are on sale now. They will include access to the concert, the final practice, and the pit stop challenge. You can get yours at IMS.com or the box office. Sam Fritz, 93 WIBC Mobile News.
You're 1 minute away from traffic and weather. It's 3:04.
Here's another remarkable success story from QC Kinetics. This one from Chad, who hurt his knee at the gym one day, and it just kept on hurting for months.
From my high school football and wrestling days, I already had a little bit of damage in there, but this just sent it over the edge.
Chad tried traditional treatments with no improvement when he turned to the non-surgical regenerative treatments at QC Kinetics.
It was really fascinating how they did their work, and the science behind it was very intriguing, and it works. Extracting the cure out of my own body blew my mind. It's like I'm brand new again. It was fantastic.
That's because the QC Kinetics natural biologic treatments use your body's own healing power to restore damaged tissue in your hips, shoulders, back, and knees, providing long-lasting relief.
Now I'm back at the gym. I'm 100%, feeling great.
If you're tired of suffering with pain from arthritis or injury, call QC Kinetics now for a free consultation.
Call QC Kinetics, 463-235-7160. That's 463-235-7160 in Eagle Creek and Greenwood. 463-235-7160.
With traffic in the fives at 3:05, good afternoon, Matt Bear.
Good afternoon, Harrison. Looking at northbound 37, that is stop and go right now. Effler 2465 and in Hendricks County. Delays starting on westbound 70. It's on westbound 70 beginning at State Road 39. Runs out to Hazelwood or for a couple of miles. And that's because of road construction. The right lane is closed. It's going on until tomorrow, 7:30 p.m. Traffic is sponsored by Grand Appliance Shop. Grand Appliance for unbeatable deals like a Mena washer starting at just $39,399. Forget the big box. Grand beats them every time. Visit grandappliance.com to learn more. I'm Matt Bear. Follow us for instant traffic updates at WIBC Traffic.
And the forecast from the American Standard Heating Weather Center.
For this afternoon, mostly sunny, breezy, wind gusts up to 35 miles an hour, high temperatures in the mid-50s. Tonight, mostly clear, low temperatures in the low to mid-30s. I'm Wish TV StormTrack 8 meteorologist Ryan Morse for 93 WIBC.
I'm Harrison Silcox, on the level, on the go, and on WIBC.com.
Hammer and Nigel.
Can you believe these characters are weirdos?
Nobody has more fun in the afternoon than we do. We are the Hammer and Nigel Show.
Nobody.
Little classic Indiana for you right there. That's Big Nige.
Hello.
I'm Jason Hammer. And this is a challenge. We always say we can make pretty much anything fun. So let's try. Let's check in with wheeling, dealing, hair sniffing, kiss stealing Joe Biden.
I got hairy legs.
I lost my Johnson. We're on track to cut First Lady in half.
So Joe Biden's campaign has pounced on Trump's bloodbath comments. You always heard the Democrats say the Republicans pounced. You know, they use that word all the time. But Biden's campaign pounced on Trump's bloodbath comments at an Ohio rally over the weekend, Hammer. First, let's go back one more time and revisit what Trump actually said involving the word bloodbath.
China now is building a couple of massive plants where they're going to build the cars in Mexico and think that they're going to sell those cars into the United States with no tax at the border. Let me tell you something to China. If you're listening, President Xi, and you and I are friends, but he understands the way I deal, those big monster car manufacturing plants that you're building in Mexico right now, and you think you're going to get that, you're going to not hire Americans, and you're going to sell the cars to us now, we're going to put a 100% tariff on every single car that comes across the line, and you're not going to be able to sell those cars. If I get elected, now, if I don't get elected, it's going to be a bloodbath for the whole... That's going to be the least of it.
Okay, you can do it. So there's that, and the liberal media spun that as... Oh, he's talking about political violence if he doesn't get elected, when in all reality he's talking about the auto industry
right.
Would be decimated.
The
right?
economics of the auto industry.
So here is the newest Biden campaign ad.
Now, if I don't get elected, it's going to be a bloodbath, and it's going to be a bloodbath for the country.
Jews will not replace us!
But you also had people that were... very fine people on both sides.
Oh, wow.
So you see, he incorporated Charlottesville and that hoax. Good
right.
people on both sides. You remember, Biden capitalized on what happened in Charlottesville.
That's how he launched right. his he, campaign,
yeah,
wasn't
he
it?
He incorporated that into his announcement to run for the president and tried to make it look like Trump is all fine and good with the Nazi protesters, which was wholly false. And he combined that with this latest hoax about the bloodbath. Didn't put any context into it whatsoever. In his attack ad. And again, like you said, Trump's talking about the auto industry. It'd be decimated if China was allowed to sell their cars for like $10,000 and no in the United States and no regulation whatsoever.
I said this yesterday and I stand by this. I was actually proud of what I saw on social media this past weekend because I saw people pushing back against bullcrap. Because normally when this kind of stuff happens, you know, people who hate Donald Trump, they pile on top. They're going to do that no matter what. But the majority of things that I saw on social media were pushing back on
yeah.
CBS and NBC saying, hold on, you're taking this out of context. And I saw more and more people sharing those views than anything else.
It happened pretty quick. With Charlottesville, I feel like it took like a long kind of time, even some conservatives to come around and saying, oh, wait, yeah, no, that's not what he was saying. But this was instant, which is good news.
And it right? just goes to show how crooked about 90% of the national media is. I mean, they are in the tank. Everything that somebody says about Fox News, fake news, they're Republican talking points. They're carrying the water for people like Joe Scarborough. Like it's the Spider-Man meme. People pointing at each other doing the same thing here.
And the whole thing is ironic since the progressive leftist media has been using the term bloodbath for years and no one said a word.
tonight on the, quote, bloodbath at the RNC.
Headlines calling it a, quote, bloodbath.
A bloodbath. Not only is it going to be a bloodbath, but after they leave New Hampshire, it's a bloodbath on her home turf. That's really tough.
And Trump has left a lot of corpses in his wake. I mean, we can count the bodies.
Really? As part of the, quote, MAGA drive to take over Maricopa County. And the headline refers to it as an impending bloodbath.
Columnist Charles Blow has a new piece for the New York Times entitled A Biden Bloodbath.
2018 midterms, you can bet that they 100% are fearing a slaughter. In fact, the word bloodbath and massacre come up frequently.
The Republican Party will be destroyed. It's going to be a bloodbath.
There's going to be a bloodbath one way or the other.
Bloodbath for Bernie Sanders.
It's been a bloodbath. They're shaping up to be a bloodbath.
Okay, I think we got the message here. It's fine when they do it. It's perfectly acceptable when they do it. But if Donald Trump's talking about the auto industry, they're going to have merch. They're going to have T-shirts. They're going to run negative campaign ads.
Meanwhile, Trump put out an attack ad of his own and entitled it Biden's Border Bloodbath. I have the whole thing. I don't think we'll play this whole thing. You'll get the idea of what this campaign attack ad is. It's, again, entitled Biden's Border Bloodbath.
We've got another tragic story connected to the border crisis. Travis Wolf was just one day away from celebrating his 12th birthday when a woman who was in the United States illegally from Venezuela crashed head-on into his family's Jeep.
Church teacher accused of abusing several children in Montgomery County, Maryland. Tonight, immigration officials tell us he was never supposed to be in the United States in the first place, and he had already been deported twice.
Palm Beach County deputies arrested three undocumented immigrants in Lake Worth Beach on sexual battery charges.
Okay, so you get the idea. That's the Trump attack ad calling it. I love it. The great alliteration here. Biden's border bloodbath.
Good. Double down on it. Give them two middle fingers up in the air. And really, if you look at the way this election's playing out, now I know it's early, it's March, we got a long way to go, but the messaging battle is mean words, mean tweets, or safety and more money in your bank account.
Yeah.
Which side do you want to be on? And I'm hoping the new leadership at the RNC doesn't trip over their own cranks and complicate this. I mean, you're True. Winning the messaging battle. Put the simple message out there, more money in your account, secure border, and everything else will take care of itself. We're checking in with Joe Biden. He's in Phoenix today, swing state of Arizona, and he's said to be announcing a, quote, national program to reach Latino voters today.
Oh, really? Is he going to tweet out a picture of himself eating a taco salad? Like Trump did?
That was Donald Trump's move back in 2016. The best taco salads are at Trump Tower. But not to be outdone, if you remember, the last time Biden said he wanted to reach Latino voters, it was in 2020. And I don't know if you remember this. He walked up to the podium at this event, and he was struggling to figure out how an iPhone works, and then he just played the song Despacito over the microphone.
I just have one thing to say. Hang on here.
Yeah.
All right.
That was it.
There you go.
That's how.
Come on.
He'll just rake in the Hispanic vote there, won't he?
He won. He won Arizona. Maybe that's the trick. Maybe Donald Trump needs to go up to Arizona with his iPhone and play hits from Menudo.
Well, you know, look, don't forget about Dr. Jill, right? I mean, Dr. Jill had a moment with the Latinos.
It's not just Joe that dabbles in folksy racism. The good doctor compared Latino voters to tacos.
As distinct as the Bogotas of the Bronx,
Bogotas.
As beautiful as the blossoms of Miami, and as unique as the breakfast tacos here in San Antonio, is your strength.
I love those awkward applauses. Did this woman just...
Compare?
Did she just call us tacos? Do we clap? I don't know. Very confusing. Both Bidens, wheeling, dealing, hair sniffing, kiss stealing Joe and the good doctor, folksy racism.
Trust me, you're not going to win the Latino vote for those people that have come here legally and gone through the process. It's taken them years and thousands of dollars to do it the right way, and all of a sudden we've got 8 million illegal immigrants in this country.
That's what Biden's banking on, those 8 million finding a way to vote. All right, Matt Baer's back. What's going on?
All right, Hammer. 2.5 miles of stop traffic in Hendricks County. Westbound 70 begins as State Road 39. Then for 2.5 miles, we are grinding through a construction zone where the right lane is blocked, and that's going on until tomorrow night at 7:30 p.m. Also, northbound 465 slows at East 56 in Lawrence. It's not bad yet. Inbound 65 stop and go 21st to a Meridian Pen. Traffic sponsored by Mattress Firm. Spread the word. You can score bonus savings on better sleep during Mattress Firm's friends and family sale. Hurry in to save up to $700 with your extra discount. Plus, get a free adjustable base on select beds. I'm Matt Baer. Follow us for instant traffic updates at WIBC Traffic.
We are streaming live. The in-studio camera is functioning. Now, I'm kind of in the shadows, but again, I've got the window open. I'm always going to look outside to Monument Circle. I'm not going to be Rob Kendall and close the blinds so we can't see what's going on in the city because you want all eyes on yourself.
It's all right.
Not going to do that. Jump in the chat house, too. YouTube is rolling. Just look for WIBC and the Hammer and Nigel show. 49. Right now at the American Standard Heating Weather Center. We got a lot of good stuff coming up. Speaking of Rob Kendall, he was all in on this Meltdown Madness matchup. We will have Meltdown Madness a little later than normal today. We'll do it about 4:48, 4:50 today. We've got the FOP president lined up. We have got an awesome show for you. Don't go anywhere. It's the Hammer and Nigel show.
When do you plan to for Social Security? Be careful here because you could set off a chain reaction of events with your taxes, IRA and 401k withdrawals, spousal benefits, and even your care premiums. And this could needlessly cost you a small fortune. Hey, it's Hammer and Nigel. Learn how you could avoid this with a free customized Social Security analysis from Bill Demery, your retirement guy, right here in Indy.
So if you've saved more than $200,000 for retirement and have not yet filed for Social Security, you've got to call Bill Demery right now. He'll give you a free analysis. Free. But you got to call 317-648-5120. 317-648-5120. Social Security, it's complicated, but Bill Demery will make it make sense for you. I've met with Bill. He's the best. 317-648-5120. Bill Demery, your retirement guy.
Jefferson Shreve stepped up to fight when no one else would. He put it all on the line. And the liberals smeared him for it with ads like this.
Donald Trump and Jefferson Shreve. He's an original supporter of Donald Trump.
They attacked Shreve for being a conservative.
Jefferson Shreve, an A rating from the NRA.
Attacked him for being a loyal Republican.
Look who was there, Jefferson Shreve. He was proud to be on the Trump campaign and proud of his own A rating from the NRA.
All because Shreve would get tough, back the blue, and stop the crime. But we don't have to accept their lawlessness at our border, in our suburbs, in our state. Because Jefferson Shreve is running for Congress, and he's a fighter for law, order, and a secure border. Jefferson Shreve for Congress.
I'm Jefferson Shreve, and I approve this message.
Paid for by Shreve for Congress.
Business. It's all the things that keep this world turning. And behind every one of these companies is a partner helping to keep it all moving. It's why the local flower shop and your favorite pizza joint, the startup in the stadium, hospitals and hotels, banks and restaurants nationwide, all choose the Advanced Network, Cybersecurity Solutions, and round-the-clock trusted partnership from Comcast Business, the company that powers more businesses than anyone else. Comcast Business, powering possibilities.
See why Comcast Business powers more small businesses than anyone else. Get started with fast speeds and advanced security for $49 a month for 12 months with a 2-year contract when you add one unlimited mobile line. Plus, ask how to get up to an $800 prepaid card with a qualifying gig bundle. Don't wait. Call to switch today. Ends 5/5/24. Restrictions apply. New customers only with 100 megabits per second internet and security edge. Eco bill and auto pay required. Equipment, taxes, and fees extra.
You love spring in Indy, but you hate to paint, so do what Judy did. She called Rhino Shield.
The house that Rhino Shield did for my husband and I, after having the house painted with kind of usual house paint, I was seeing cracks appearing about every 3 years and just wasn't very satisfied with that.
Rhino Shield's a ceramic coating specifically formulated for our unique climate.
I can't speak highly enough about the Rhino Shield crew. They also were great at working with me to get the exact right color because I was very particular.
Indy, you too can have the guaranteed protection of Rhino Shield right now for 15% off the regular price.
I would not hesitate to call Rhino Shield, and I am just thrilled to recommend Rhino Shield to my friends and neighbors and family.
Here's Rhino Shield's Shane Smith.
This offer is limited, so call me at 888-RHINO-41. That's 888-RHINO-41.
Don't paint.
Don't vinyl.
Go Rhino!
Paint your house again. Rhino Shield!
You're listening to the Hammer and Nigel Show.
Yeah, Miller Lite Card Day concert has been announced, ladies and gentlemen. Always that Friday before the race. This is happening Friday, May 24th. George Thorogood and the Destroyers.
Friend of the show.
That's right,
George Thorogood. George, he's been on with us a couple times.
He's going to be joined by special guest Gin Blossoms, who will be opening the show. I'm down. I'm all for it. I love it. I like it. And I guess the gates are going to open at 2 o'clock this year. More entertainment this year, by the way. Indie-based rapper and recording artist Kid Quill will also be performing.
Now, I know you celebrate Kid Quill's entire catalog, don't you, Nige?
I've not heard Kid Quill until they announced this today.
You good with the show, though?
Yeah. Are you kidding me? It's got a little something for everybody. It's got, you know, some classic rock, Gin Blossoms for the Gen Xers, and, well, a local rapper.
Right. And, man, George Thorogood, we've talked about this before. He's one of those artists where you don't realize how many hits this guy really has until you start hearing them one right after the other. Like his concert, it's like a greatest hits on parade, man. That's what it is. So my question to you, Nige, is Bad to the Bone the signature song of George Thorogood? If I were to do a Family Feud style survey on Monument Circle, we surveyed 100 random people. Name a George Thorogood song. Is that the number one answer?
Absolutely, unequivocally, 100%.
Some other really good hits by George Thorogood. I Drink Alone.
Sure.
Something you and I have done our fair share of in our life. One bourbon, one scotch,
one beer.
So good. If you don't start drinking, there's a theme with George Thorogood songs.
Sounds like it. Budweiser, Budweiser, Miller Lite.
And Hammer and Nigel Records, we've had a little fun with some of George Thorogood's hits over the years. Like take Bad to the Bone, for example. Mm-hmm. We've used that, not necessarily with Hammer and Nigel Records, but when we do our series called Lindsey Graham Tough Guy.
Lindsey Graham Tough Guy.
So if you don't like me working with President Trump to make the world a better place, I don't give a shit.
Lindsey Graham, tough guy.
Another big hit was Who Do You Love, to which we used when Joe Biden was celebrating Pride.
I mean this from the bottom of my heart. Marriage is a simple proposition. Who do you love?
Come on, take a little walk with me, baby, and tell me who do you love?
Who do you love?
Move It On Over is another
moving
favorite.
Moving On Over.
Moving On Over. Hammer and Nigel Records, when COVID was, we thought it was gone, but then it started to come back a little bit later in the year. Hammer and Nigel Records put out this little ditty.
The results came in about a 10:30. I can't believe I got the virus again. Because COVID ain't over.
COVID ain't over.
COVID ain't over. Calling to my doctor, say I'm coming in. My wife's best friend just changed the locks, cause her man came home with the monkey bar.
Oh, no.
It's not over.
It's not over.
COVID's not over.
COVID's not over. shot.
Bravo.
There it is.
Okay.
Hammer and Nigel Records. COVID ain't over.
Yeah, that's going to be in my head for the rest of the day. COVID ain't over. So, by the way, Gin Blossoms have their own fair share of hits. They have a big catalog.
Right.
Hey, Jealousy, Until I Fall Away, Found Out About You, Allison Road. I mean, New Miserable Experience was a huge hit back in the early 90s. And the congratulations, I'm sorry, their next album with, Follow You Down and As Long As It Matters were giant songs. So it's going to be another band that you're going to be surprised how many songs you know.
Right. And that's what you want when you go to, like, Carb Day, right? You want to have some drinks. You want to be out in the sun. You want to sing along to all the songs that you know and you love. And I think this is a great show. I mean, this is perfect for that atmosphere. And hat tip to Doug Bowles, because what he does to try to get different types of people into the Motor Speedway, I think is awesome. So he's decided to make the Snake Pit on race day this big, awesome techno concert that brings in the young folks, gets them exposed to the Indy 500. You've got the old folks like us that enjoy the Carb Day concerts with, like, you know, the hair bands and the rock bands. And now you got some younger Gen Xers in there with the Gin Blossoms. The Legends Day concert's usually a country theme type show. So good stuff. I like everything they're doing over there at the Indianapolis Motor Speedway. It's the Hammer and Nigel Show.
So my wife and I were thinking about adding on an extra room to our house to give us a little more space. But then again, our sidewalk and front porch were just absolutely falling apart and needed completely replaced. We decided that was more important. And I'm so glad we chose that option, because Indy Decorative Concrete absolutely blew me away with the job that they did, and actually gave me more space, more value when compared to doing a lousy room addition. So much more entertaining and usable space out front of my house. And the install went so quick, 3 days. Funny thing is, before we chose Indy Decorative Concrete, I was just going to go with the basic, regular, generic concrete that looked the same as before. No, they turned a basic sidewalk and porch into a custom-stamped concrete area, again, with more space and an awesome, unique look. They don't use subcontractors. Everyone who works for them is a W-2 employee. In fact, the owner's son-in-law was our project manager. Hey, got to get on the books now. They're starting to get really busy. Go to IndyDecorativeConcrete.com. Whether it's a new patio, sidewalk, porch, or whatever, don't do anything, again, until you've checked out IndyDecorativeConcrete.com.
Hey guys, it's Rob. Did you know Universal Windows Direct does a lot more than just windows? You can get a new home at the same address with vinyl siding from Universal Windows Direct. Their exclusive Unishield Supreme siding delivers the warm, quality appearance of wood without the costly, time-consuming maintenance and repairs. But wait, Universal Windows Direct does even more. Make a great first impression and increase your home's curb appeal with a new entry door from Universal Windows Direct. Or how about this? Clogged gutters will cause major damage to your home, foundation problems, basement flooding, and more. With Universal Windows Direct, you'll never have to worry about cleaning your gutters again with their gutter protection system. Give your home a new glow. Call today at 317-659-7574 to schedule your free in-home estimate. And for every two windows you buy, you get the next two free. And tell them Rob Kendall told you to call and you'll get $250 off your project. Windows, siding, doors, gutters, and more. Universal Windows Direct, 317-659-7574.
Pizza's here.
Oh, great. I'd love some, but I'm worried about my stomach issues.
If you're worried about having diarrhea, gas, bloating, stomach pain, or loose, oily stools, it may not just be stomach issues. It could be a condition called exocrine pancreatic insufficiency, or EPI. With EPI, the pancreas doesn't release enough enzymes to break down food, but EPI is manageable. Use the symptom checker on IdentifyEPI.com and talk to your doctor. That's IdentifyEPI.com. Sponsored by AbbVie.
93 WIPC Mobile News. On the level. On the go.
Why he's out of a job. Mostly sunny, 48 degrees in downtown Indianapolis. Your radar's clear. Low temps drop to the upper 30s tonight. I'm Harrison Silcox. Here's what's trending at 3:30. A dispute between a corrections officer in Henry County and an inmate led to the officer being fired and now facing charges for shooting that inmate with a pepper ball.
The corrections officer, told him to face the wall. I believe the inmate said, "I am facing the effing wall." There was just a couple of of back and forth, and they deployed the pepper ball round.
Sheriff John Sproles, the corrections officer, will go on trial this July. A U.N. agency is warning of famine in the Gaza Strip. Fox's Jared Halpern explains.
A United Nations report put together by a coalition of international aid organizations warns famine may already be happening in parts of Gaza. Aboard Air Force One, White House Press Secretary Karine Jean-Pierre says that report is a stark reminder everyone needs to do more.
Israel needs to provide sustained and unimpeded access for assistance to enter both northern and southern Gaza.
An Israeli delegation is expected in Washington early next week to hear concerns from the Biden administration on plans for a major Israeli military incursion into the southern city of Rafah. In Washington, Jared Halpern, Fox News.
Crime rates in the United States are going down, says the FBI. That's supported by data from the final 3 months of last year when violent crime fell by 6% from the year before. Murders also dropped by 13%. The FBI says the data came from about 13,000 law enforcement agencies across the country. You can't just expect any pair of glasses to get the job done when it comes to protecting your eyes during a solar eclipse. They need to be ISO certified.
When you actually open up the glasses, the ones that I have seen have that certification on the inside of one of the arms of the glasses, so typically along the left arm on the inside of it.
Dr. Sarah Olvey with Peyton Manning Children's Carmel Pediatrics says it's especially important for kids to wear them because their eyes aren't as developed compared to adults. The moon is expected to pass between the sun and Earth on April 8th. About half the state is in the path of totality. You're 1 minute away from traffic and weather. It's 3:32.
A house isn't a home without a little wear and tear, spilled milk, or muddy paws. But don't just clean it, quick shine it. Hey, Pat Sullivan here for Quick Shine Finishes and Cleaners with some floor care 101 tips. First, no matter the surface type, be sure to remove dust and debris. Avoid heavy chemicals or all-purpose liquids as they can damage the sealant layer or leave an oily residue. Now, to best clean and protect your floors at a modest price, don't just clean it, quick shine it. Quick Shine Finishes and Cleaners use ingredients that make it better for kids, pets, and the environment with an EPA Safer Choice certification. And QuickShine has a full line of products to treat any surface, including their floor cleaner, floor finisher, and hardwood floor luster. I use it on my own floors. Made right here in Central Indiana for over 60 years by Holloway House, a family-owned company. QuickShine Finishes and Cleaners is available at retailers everywhere.
With traffic at 3:33, what's going on, Matt Bear?
Harrison, looking at westbound 70 Hendricks County, we have a stopped traffic for about 2.5 miles. It starts at State Road 39 a little bit before now and runs over to Hazelwood. That's about 2.5 miles of road construction zone because the right lane is closed, and that's going on until tomorrow night at 7:30 p.m. Southbound 65 stop and go to downtown 21st Meridian Penn and a crash on the north side 82nd Street at Clear Vista. Traffic sponsored by Drexel Interiors. Go where the pros go. Drexel Interiors for Timberlake Kitchen and Bath Cabinets. Visit Drexel's Design Centers at 146th Street and River Road or on North Shadeland online at DrexelIN.com. I'm Matt Bear. Follow us for instant traffic updates at IBC traffic.
And the forecast from the American Standard Heating Weather Center.
We'll be mostly clear and a little breezy for our Tuesday night with lows falling into the mid-30s. Then for Wednesday, still lots of sunshine around, but a little cooler with highs in the mid-upper 40s due to a breezy northwesterly wind and also dry as well. I'm Wish TV StormTrack 8 meteorologist Stephen Deanna from 93 WIBC.
I'm Harrison Silcox on The Level on the Go and on WIBC.com.
Crime. Punishment. Judges. Legal stuff.
Breaking the laws. Hammer Nigel Show. Hi, I'm Nigel. Hammer's here. Trump. Well, for once, Trump is doing the suing.
Wow.
It's been him getting all the lawsuits thrown his way. Now he's actually suing ABC News and George Stephanopoulos for defamation.
All right, Allison, I want to see how much you pay attention to the Hammer and Nigel Show. Normally, when I refer to George Stephanopoulos or Snuffleupagus, I say he's one of the great what of all time.
Why'd you just sell me the spot?
I know it.
What is it, Nigel?
Butt sniffers.
Bingo! One of the great butt sniffers of all time.
So during this interview on ABC News, Stephanopoulos said Trump was found liable for rape several times, talking about the E. Jean Carroll case where she sued him civilly, which was not true. Rape was never anywhere in the documents.
Right.
It was sexual assault.
Right? Here is the exact moment.
Yep.
This is what Donald Trump is suing about. This is when In Your Face Nancy Mace was on with George Snuffleupagus. And there were a lot of things wrong with this interview. Like, Nancy had her own issues with Butt Sniffer McGee, but that was something different. Listen to what old Georgie Poo says about Donald.
You've endorsed Donald Trump for president.
Right.
Donald Trump has been found liable for rape by a jury. Donald Trump has been found liable for defaming the victim of that rape by a jury. It's been affirmed by a judge.
It was not a criminal court case, number one. Number two, I live with shame. And you're asking me a question about my political choices, trying to shame me as a rape victim, and I find it disgusting.
So that was just a small part, yeah. But you heard what George said.
And he was grilling her on it for like 9 minutes. Really creepy and gross, too.
Right.
To try to make that connection there. And it, you're right. A federal jury in New York, Trump was not liable for rape. He was liable for sexual abuse. Sexual abuse could be like I walk up to a random girl on the sidewalk and smack her in the ass. I could be arrested for sexual abuse, right?
Right.
Nowhere in any of the documents in this civil lawsuit with the final judgment was the word rape.
And calling somebody a convicted rapist on national television is a pretty big deal.
Especially when you've been a lifelong associate of Bill Clinton and his clan.
Right. And when really? I say butt sniffer, for those who don't know, I mean somebody that is so wed to the party, they can do nothing wrong. And this little guy, and he's a little dude, George is, all he does is walk around and just do that to whatever Democrats in charge or whatever Democrats running for office, the way like new dogs meet each other. That's what George Snuffleupagus does to whatever Democrat can keep him still relevant. One of the great butt sniffers of all time. Donald Trump's poll numbers, for those who buy poll numbers, again, I'm not all in, but some of these are interesting. Like when you break it down into specific categories, you've got my attention. Poll numbers with the black community have got my attention because for so long, that was just a guaranteed vote for the political left in this country, right? Candidates change, names change, but certain minorities would always just vote for certain candidates. That's just the way that it works. But this election shaping up to be a little different. Now, I'm not going to sit here and tell you that Donald Trump is going to win the minority vote, but he's doing better than any Republican in recent memory. You sent me a story earlier today about how this
This is from CBS. Are you kidding me? I wish you could see the look on the CBS reporter's face, Hammer. They were interviewing a black couple who supported Obama, and then she was just shocked on who they're going to vote for in this upcoming 2024 presidential election.
In 2008 and 2012, you voted for
Barack Obama.
Barack Obama. 2016.
I voted for Donald Trump.
Hillary Clinton. 2020.
Donald Trump.
Biden. And who will you vote for in 2024?
Donald Trump.
Donald Trump. You may vote for the former president.
I may.
Why do you say that?
My views on certain things have changed. I am very much so riding the fence.
What are you struggling with?
Being in a pattern of doing the same thing that I've been doing, because it's kind of like second nature. Like when you go in a poll, you hit Democrat. Something has to happen. I mean, it's just so expensive to survive. And we're planning on having kids. I don't want to live in a stressful environment trying to rub two pennies together to try to make it either.
The economy.
That's it.
So, I mean, if you look right now, 23% of black voters support President Trump as of February. This was in the New York Times. We talked about this. That's a massive increase from where his support was in October 2020 in the African-American community. 4% in 2020. Now it's up to 23%. That's a big jump.
The whole, he's mean. He's mean on Twitter. He says embarrassing things crap isn't going to fly anymore because people have seen what happens when you vote for woke issues compared to lowering your groceries or lowering your gas prices or pretty much anything that's out there. I mean, you look at the CPI index report that comes out, and it's all just horrendous ever since Joe Biden was sworn in as the president. Now, does Donald Trump bear some responsibility? Probably. I'm not going to sit here and say he doesn't, you know, deserve any blame. But the facts are, when Donald Trump was the president compared to when Joe Biden is the president, things were cheaper and people had more money in their pockets. Allison, I think we need some mood music here. Just eat it. Eat it. Get yourself an egg and
feed it. This website, Eat This, Not That, ranked the 25 unhealthiest drinks on the planet.
Tequila.
I think they're talking more about like fruit juices and energy drinks and stuff like that. Number one, and they're all basing this in terms of the sugar content. And you know, it's like some of these drinks try to pass themselves off as health drinks or, you know, a substitute for meals, smoothies. Oh, it's all healthy. It's got fruit in it and stuff. No, it's got a ton of sugar.
This margarita's got some lime wedge in it. It's fine.
Have you ever heard of Naked Mighty Mango Juice? Anybody in here heard of that? No? No? That's number
one. I loved the Naked Juices in college. That's all I would drink because I thought they were a healthy alternative for breakfast.
It feels like that should be a promo that we air at some point. Allison saying she loved the Naked Juices back in college.
It's one of those healthy looking...
What? You said it. Don't roll your eyes at me. You were the one that said it.
What's number two?
Naked Blue Machine Juice. 55 grams of sugar, same company that makes the Naked Mighty Mango Juice. These are, like, again, the healthy-looking juices that are in the produce department, right?
Right.
If you buy, like, you and I drink Monster occasionally. Ooh, did I forget my Monster back in the fridge?
You got one in the fridge.
Okay. 54 grams in at number three, but we drink the ones that don't have any sugar in it.
You know why? Because we're health nuts.
That's right.
Some of us care about our bodies a little more than others.
The Arizona Sweet Tea, 53 grams. In at number five, Naked Green Machine, 53
grams.
Boy,
the Naked Company,
yeah,
man.
I've never heard that. Starbucks Frappuccino. I can't believe that only has 47 grams in it. That's the Frappuccino's like the wide mouth glass bottle. Mountain Dew in at number seven, Hammer, 46 grams.
But again, like the Monster Energy argument, I'm on zero sugars. Mountain Dew, zero sugar. Even better than Diet Mountain Dew.
Let's see here. Welch's Grape Juice, 44 grams. Arizona Green Tea, 42 grams. And there's a few more on here that you might not realize have a ton of sugar, like Vitamin Water. I used to love a good Vitamin Water, for sure. V8 Splash, Ginger Ale, Tonic Water has almost as much sugar per ounce as Yoo-Hoo.
The only time I drink ginger ale is if there's a bourbon or a whiskey mixed with
it. Yeah, I love Jameson and ginger ale.
Oh, that's so good.
For sure. But
we've got both of those in the back.
We've got ginger ale in the back?
Yes, I've got ginger ale in the back, and you brought the Jameson in.
I wish you hadn't said that.
I know what we're doing during commercial.
You know what? I'm surprised Coke, I don't know what the numbers are on Coke. I try to limit my soda consumption, but I do have a weakness for a can of Coke every once in a while. I can't believe that's not on the top 10.
I'm a fountain Coke at McDonald's guy, but I've tried not to drink the regular ones anymore. One, because it's a lot of calories. Two, it's a lot of sugar. I don't drink coffee, so I got to get my caffeine fixed. So I've got my Mountain Dew zeros. I'm down to two a day. I used to be drinking 2 44-ounces a day.
39 grams in a 12-ounce can of Coke. And some people make the argument that it's healthier to just drink the stuff with the real sugar in it than the aspartame or whatever crap they put in the diet to make it taste good. You know what I mean?
Right. Man, there's so few things you can drink other than just plain water that anybody's going to say is good for you. I get it. Drinking Coke is bad. Drinking whiskey is bad. Drinking tequila is bad. Goldschlager, bad. Do they even make Goldschlager anymore?
I don't know. I have to look that up.
That was the spring break drink of choice for young Jason Hammer back in 1996 and 1997.
That's like, you know, I think Fireball has kind of replaced Goldschlager as that college drink.
Panama City, Goldschlager had that crap that was floating around in it.
Fireball's so bad for, let's just talk about all the sugar and all the high fructose corn syrup.
I think we got some in the back, too.
Oh, no.
Allison, commercial break right now.
Your new car, your new truck, your new electric vehicle is at Andy Moore Ford in Plainfield because they've got the deal that can't be beat. All of the new cars and trucks you're looking for and electric vehicles like the all-electric F-150 Lightning with seating up to 5, intelligent backup power, and on-site power for all your tools and gear. This all-electric truck is built for it all. Andy Moore Ford also has the rebates for you. Federal and state incentives. You could save more on your EV purchase up to $7,500 instantly on site and save more on all of their cars and trucks, their fleet vehicles, and their electric vehicles. Andy Moore Ford in Plainfield, including more to your door. You can just buy the car online and they will deliver it directly to you. Andy Moore Ford. Visit them on Main Street in Plainfield or online at andymooreford.com. That's Andy Moore, M-O-H-R. I love Andy. andymooreford.com.
Congresswoman Spartz will be ready for your interview soon.
It seems pretty intense in there.
Yeah, kind of crazy. Maybe I'll take some time before the interview to Google Victoria Spartz and learn a little more about her. Whoa, have you seen this article?
One aide calling the lawmakers' workplace behavior manic?
Victoria Spartz was number one on Legistorm's list of worst bosses based on high turnover rates.
Says she, quote, avoided firing aides and instead bullied them until they left.
And the story is based on interviews with half a dozen former staffers.
Yikes. Spartz called staff morons and idiots.
Get this. Victoria Spartz says her working style is, quote, not for everyone.
Well, it's not for me. I think I'll pass on this interview.
I'm Chuck Goodrich. I'm running for Congress, and I approve this message.
Paid for by Go With Chuck Goodrich Committee.
Now is the perfect time for you to call the Bath Authority to get your project you've been putting off done this spring. Because the Bath Authority has an unbelievable deal going on. Call today at 317-532-5711. 317-532-5711. Schedule your free in-home estimate and get $1,000 off a new shower or bath, plus 36 months of interest-free financing. That's right. All you got to do is call today at 317-532-5711. Schedule a free in-home estimate with the Bath Authority and get $1,000 off a new shower or bath, plus 36 months of interest-free financing. Walk-in tubs, replacement showers, tub-to-shower conversions, and more. The Bath Authority does it all. 317-532-5711 for $1,000 off a new shower or bath, plus 36 months of interest-free financing. TheBathAuthority.com. Tell them Rob sent you.
I was struggling to maintain contact with the professional world.
Dr. Ferner of Indianapolis talks about why he got the new CapTel Caption phone from Relay Indiana.
When I got the CapTel phone, it turned it around.
Go to RelayIndiana.com. That's RelayIndiana.com. And read up on the CapTel Caption phone.
People that I talk with do not necessarily know that I have this CapTel service. It's a piece of cake.
Go to RelayIndiana.com to learn more.
Hi, it's Bob from Royal Spa. Soaking in a hot tub full of Epsom salts is the absolute best way to minimize everyday aches and pains. And we know all about Epsom salts at Royal Spa. Royal Spa hot tubs are the only hot tubs on the market that can safely and effectively use Epsom salts. Made right here in Indiana, Royal Spa hot tubs are the highest quality hot tubs on the market. Visit any one of our three Indianapolis locations or visit RoyalSpa.com.
Ah, Royal Spa.
Indy's leader in patio installation is now offering a new driveway package. Schedule a free estimate today at IndyDecorativeConcrete.com. That's IndyDecorativeConcrete.com.
Go where the pros go. Drexel Interiors for Timberlake Kitchen and Bath Cabinets. Visit Drexel's new design center on 146th Street at River Road or on North Shadeland. DrexelIN.com.
Never miss your favorite shows on WIPC. Get your content to go. Tony Katz, Kendall and Casey, Hammer and Nigel, Tony Kennett, The Gun Guy, Home and Garden. Subscribe wherever you get your podcasts.
So we were talking earlier about Donald Trump filing this lawsuit against ABC News and George Stephanopoulos. Rich on the YouTube chat, Trump should sue George for $453 million.
We just picked a number. I don't know why that's the number. It just is.
That's how much he owes the state of New York. Coincidentally.
Matt Bear, what's up?
Hydroxychloroquine. Sorry, I can't do it as well.
Remdesivir. Ivermectin.
Made my day. Westbound 70 stopped right now in Hendricks County for 3 months.
Dexamethasone.
Westbound 70. I can't do it like you can. Westbound 70 stopped right now, a mile before State Road 39, 3 mile delay in total because of construction in Hendricks County. The right lane is blocked right now until tomorrow night at 7:30 p.m. Also, northbound 37 stops Epler Avenue to 465 because of construction. Crash Carmel 106 at Hazeldale Parkway. Another one on the northeast side, 82nd at Clare Vista Parkway. Traffic sponsored by Drexel Interiors. Go where the pros go. Drexel Interiors for Timberlake Kitchen and Bath Cabinets. Visit Drexel's Design Centers at 146th Street and River Road or on North Shadeland online at DrexelIN.com. I'm Matt Bear. Follow us for instant traffic updates at WIBC Traffic.
Dunning Dick. 49.
Oh, yeah.
At the American Standard Heating Weather Center. It's the Hammer and Nigel Show.
You're listening to the Hammer and Nigel Show.
We have a mutual fondness for this YouTube channel. It's called There I Ruined It. Hammer, you know this channel, right?
I love it.
It takes popular songs and kind of mashes them up with a different song in a totally different genre.
Right.
And basically just ruins it for you, right?
So right.
Do you want to hear the latest one?
Please.
This is Sir Mix-a-Lot's Baby Got Back in the style of Simon and Garfunkel.
I like big butts, I cannot lie. You other brothers can't deny. When a girl walks in with an itty bitty waist and a round thing in your face, you get sprung, cause you notice that butt was stuffed.
Yes, sir.
You pull up tough. Deep in the jeans she's wearing, what you gonna do with all that junk?
Oh, I think he's switching up.
This is my humps.
All that junk inside that trunk.
Okay, all right.
I'ma get you drunk. Get you love drunk off my humps. What you gonna do with all that inside them jeans? Gonna make you scream. My hum, my hum, my hum.
There I ruined it.
Love it.
With a little baby got back.
Did you fill out your March Madness bracket? You're kind of down on yourself about you.
I hate myself for the teams that I've got in the Final Four. I'm like embarrassed. But if we're trying to play to win, like you play to win the game.
Sure.
I've got Kentucky in the Final Four.
Oh, boy.
All right. I don't like it any more than you do.
Here are all the mascots in the NCAA tournament in less than 60 seconds. Go. Ready? Go. Here we go.
Boilermakers, Bobcats, Bears, Bison, and Badgers. You got a pair of Dukes, Spartans, Gales, Flyers, and Lancers. Golden Eagles, Golden Grizzlies, Crimson Tide, Red Raiders. Blue Jays, Blue Devils, Cyclones, and Gators. Huskies, Hatters, Five Bulldogs, Antelopes, Jackrabbits, and Horned Frogs. Cowboys, Two Aggies, Longhorns, Broncos. 34 down, 34 to go.
Come on!
Four Cougars, Catamounts, Cornhuskers, Cavaliers. Ducks, Owls, Eagles, Hilltoppers, the Volunteers. Tar Heels, Blazers, Raiders, Rams, and Jayhawks. Fighting Illini, Aztecs, and Peacocks. Three Wildcats, Three Tigers, Lobos. The Beach, Seahawks, Gamecocks, Buffaloes. Wolfpack, twice the Zips, that's it. Write them down, fill out your brackets. It's March Madness.
I love it. I love it.
Are we going to get your buddies on the show at any point, your gambling gurus, guys?
Tomorrow. Yes, they're going to give us a little March Madness gambling advice tomorrow.
Cool.
David Stefanoff, who's a professional sports handicapper from followneverfade.com. Scott Long, comedian, fellow degenerate that does programs with me. We're going to get those guys on tomorrow, and we'll break it down just a little bit. But coming up next, quick update on the Delphi situation. Long, bizarre, crazy day in court yesterday. We've also got Is This Anything? We got the FOP president, Rick Snyder, and Meltdown Madness. A big 4 o'clock hour is coming up.
We'll be back right after the news, right here on 93 WIBC.
Get ready for storm season, because you know as well as I do, storms in Indiana can be fierce and they can come out of nowhere. So don't wait for a leak to have your roof inspected. Have peace of mind about your roof being able to handle any storm. Moss Roofing, M-O-S-S, mossroofing.com provides free inspections and can spot potential issues before they turn into costly repairs. Whether you're looking for a siding replacement after a strong wind or a roof replacement after a hailstorm, Moss Roofing has options that fit any budget. Just ask Moss Roofing about their payment plans. No matter your situation, Moss Roofing has you covered with a job done right every single time. I love that. That's very funny. Contact Moss Roofing today. 317-747-3665. 317-747-3665. Tell them Tony Katz sent you. Moss Roofing, 747-3665, or online at Moss, M-O-S-S, mossroofing.com.
Business. It's not a 9-to-5 proposition. It's all day and into the night. It's all the things that keep this world turning. And behind every one of these businesses is a partner like Comcast Business, helping to keep it all moving. It's why the local flower shop and your favorite pizza joint, the startup and the stadium, hospitals and hotels, banks and restaurants nationwide, all these businesses choose the advanced network, cybersecurity solutions, and round-the-clock trusted partnership from Comcast Business. From Main Street to Wall Street, our people are powering the businesses that power it all. So when you're ready to unlock what's possible for your business, there's no one better to answer the call. Comcast Business, powering possibilities.
Restrictions apply. Call or visit ComcastBusiness.com to learn more.
Smith Plumbing. A dirty, stinking honest.
When plumbing problems arise, you need them fixed fast and right. The L.D. Smith Plumbing crew knows how to put water in its place. We do it all, from the kitchen sink to delicate repairs in historic homes. And we'll always give you honest advice at a fair price. So if you're worried about the cost of plumbing repairs, call today for a free second opinion on a competitor's estimate.
L.D. Smith Plumbing.
A dirty, stinking honest.
Life insurance. Why are you putting it off? Can't afford it? Too much hassle? Think you don't need it? There's lots of excuses for putting off life insurance. But if you weren't there, who would pay the mortgage and other bills? With Ethos, you could be covered in 10 minutes and boom, family protected. Ethos, fast and easy online term life insurance. Up to $2 million in coverage with no medical exam. Some policies as low as a dollar a day. Answer a few health questions and get your free quote at getethos.com. That's getethos.com.
Cancer's worst gets our best. Franciscan Health is a national leader in treating colorectal cancer, achieving the highest standards in cancer care. With accredited programs, board-certified oncologists, and fellowship-trained colorectal surgeons, Franciscan Health is focused on your future, offering the most advanced treatments and latest clinical trials that are no match for colorectal cancer. Meet colorectal cancer's toughest opponent at franciscanhealth.org/coloncancercare. That's franciscanhealth.org/coloncancercare.
Hey, this is Spencer Thompson at Thompson Furniture and Mattress in Columbus. If you missed the biggest outdoor furniture sale of the season at Thompson Furniture, then you're in luck. We've extended the sale now through April Fool's Day. No joke, the best outdoor furniture by Berlin Gardens in Pollywood is on sale. Little to no maintenance, lasts for decades, leave it outside all year long. Sale ends April Fool's Day only at Thompson Furniture and Mattress in Columbus.
Coming up in 2 minutes, why today's weather is a bit of a fire hazard. Indiana State Police are investigating ghost employment at an Indiana Police Department. Wes Woodward will have that story. And how you can properly protect yourself during this solar eclipse. All that and more coming up after Fox News Radio from the Technology Recyclers Studios. You are listening to 93 WIBC, WIBC HD1 Indianapolis. It's 4 o'clock.
A surprise from the U.S. Supreme Court. I'm Lisa Brady, Fox News. The justice is lifting a stay on a Texas law that allows police to arrest migrants suspected of crossing from Mexico illegally and potentially deport them without turning them over to Border Patrol. Governor Greg Abbott calls it a game changer. Fox's Nate Foy is in Eagle Pass.
So essentially how it would work is they would have to see a migrant crossing illegally, and then they could just charge that migrant with criminal trespassing, take them to a judge who then would give the migrant the option to go back to Mexico or go through the court process and be charged with that crime, rather than how it works right now, where the migrants go to Border Patrol to be processed and ultimately very often released into the country.
Today's divided Supreme Court decision means Texas can enforce the new law while the legal fight continues. There were dissents from three liberal justices, including Sonia Sotomayor, who wrote that allowing enforcement invites further chaos and crisis. Former President Trump just filing a brief with the Supreme Court ahead of arguments next month in his bid for immunity from prosecution in a federal election interference case. The brief reiterates his arguments that the president can't function and presidency can't retain independence if the president faces criminal prosecution for official acts once he leaves office. Senate Majority Leader Chuck Schumer just ripping the former president on the Senate floor after he said Jewish people who vote for Democrats hate their religion and hate Israel.
To say you hate Israel or your religion because you have one political view over the other is sick, it's hateful. It is unadulterated anti-Semitism.
Schumer accusing the former president of pushing a loyalty trope. The Senate leader has faced some bipartisan criticism for his recent public rebuke of the Israeli prime minister over the situation in Gaza. Stocks finished higher, the Dow up 320. America's listening to Fox News.
93 WIBC Mobile News. On the level. On the go.
It's not a great combo. Sunny at 50 degrees in downtown Indianapolis. We've got a clear radar downtown. Low of 38 expected tonight. I'm Harrison Silcox for Moss Roofing. Here's what's trending at 402. It's dry and windy in central Indiana, which also happens to be a fire hazard.
Really, when we're looking for elevated fire dangers, we're looking for low fuel moisture, so very dry conditions outside, low humidity, and then high wind gusts.
Greg Mello with the National Weather Service in Indianapolis. He says winds will be strong enough to knock over any loose objects outside, and there's a chance for some isolated power outages. Indiana State Police are investigating ghost employments in police departments in LaPorte County, Wes Woodward reports.
According to the investigation, which started with the Long Beach Police Department, Officer Jason Yagelski claimed hours worked at two different police departments at the same time on numerous occasions, resulting in him being paid several thousand dollars for hours not actually worked. He was employed by three police departments in LaPorte County. Yagelski has been charged with two felony counts each of ghost employment and official misconduct, and one count of misdemeanor fraud, and has since posted bond after being booked at the LaPorte County Jail. Wes Woodward, 93 WIBC Mobile News.
A corrections officer from Henry County is no longer employed and faces charges of shooting an inmate with a pepper ball last month.
I went ahead and terminated him the next morning. When I reviewed the camera and was talking to my chief deputy, I said, just right off the bat, I mean, I can't deal with that type of language. Obviously, the deploying the pepper ball round was under investigation.
Henry County Sheriff John Sproul is at trial for former officer Curtis Dowdy is this June. A lot of legal maneuvering. That's what continues to happen in the Delphi murder case. John Heverick reports on what happened Monday.
Special Judge Fran Gull agreed to add two new charges of murder while committing or attempting to commit kidnapping against Richard Allen, who is accused of killing Abby Williams and Libby German in Delphi back in 2017. The judge did, however, reject the prosecutor's proposition to add standalone kidnapping charges. Allen's murder trial is still scheduled for May 13th in Carroll County. John Herrick, 93 WIBC Mobile News.
You'll need the right pair of glasses to protect your vision if you want to catch a glimpse of the solar eclipse April 8th.
But these are glasses that would have to be worn 100% of the time during the solar eclipse if they're going to be looking directly at the sun.
Dr. Sarah Olvey with Peyton Manning Children's Carmel Pediatrics says the glasses need to have ISO certification. Traffic and weather in 60 seconds. Your time is 4:04.
Do you get sinus infections? Congestion, sinus pressure and pain, above your eyes, below your eyes, sinus headaches. You've gone to the doctor, you've visited urgent care over and over again, and it's always the same thing.
Oh, I know. Let's try antibiotics and nasal sprays.
But the sinus infections keep coming back. The good news? Relief is possible. How? A minimally invasive procedure done in the office of Indianapolis Sinus Center. called balloon sinuplasty. Imagine the relief of not having to deal with your sinus infections anymore. Set an appointment today with Indianapolis Sinus Center and find out if balloon sinuplasty is the solution for you. Call 317-528-9650. 317-528-9650. That's 317-528-9650.
The traffic on the 5s at 4:05. Here's Matt Baer.
All right, Harrison, Carmel, Hazeldale Parkway shut down from 106 to 116th Street because of a crash. A vehicle rolled. And then westbound 70 Hendricks County stop between the county line and Hazelwood. That's about a 3-mile delay right now because of road construction. Right lane closed. It's going on until tomorrow night at 7:30. Crash northeast side 82nd to Clear Vista. Northbound 37 stops. Epler 2465. Into downtown. Eastbound 70 stop and go from Belmont to Meridian, Illinois. Inbound 65 stop and go traffic 21st to Meridian Penn. Traffic sponsored by Robert Half. 9 out of 10 hiring managers are having difficulty hiring today. Robert Half is here to help. At Robert Half, they know talent. Visit roberthalf.com today. I'm Matt Baer. Follow us for instant traffic updates at WIBC Traffic.
And the forecast from the American Standard Heating Weather Center.
It'll be mostly clear and a little breezy for our Tuesday night with lows falling into the mid-30s. Then for Wednesday, still lots of sunshine around, but a little cooler with highs in the mid-upper 40s due to a breezy northwesterly wind and also dry as well. I'm Wish TV Storm Track 8 meteorologist Stephen Deanna for 93 WIBC.
I'm Harrison Silcox on the level on the go and on WIBC.com.
Hammer and Nigel.
Do you believe these characters are weirdos?
So let's rock it!
My name is Nigel. Jason Hammer right over there. Let's start with Donald Trump and his civil fraud trial. You remember he was found guilty of fraud there in New York. Basically, they said the attorney general and the judge said he overvalued his assets to get better bank loans, which, you know, remember, there was no evidence of any injured party or ever being defrauded whatsoever.
There was no victim.
There was no victim in this payback. But anyway. So, what was the judgment? $454 million?
Yes.
Which is ridiculous. Obviously, this is in coordination with the Biden Justice Department, almost inevitably. Letitia James went to go visit Biden, his administration, before she brought these charges. So, Trump's team is, I guess what he's doing is trying to approach multiple financial firms to get the bond, but nobody's willing to put up their cash against his assets.
Right.
And the deadline is Monday. And Monday comes, old Letitia James is going to be able to start going all after his properties around the city. And she said she, quote, would not hesitate to do.
So Trump Tower in New York, all these golf courses, the hotels, maybe Mar-a-Lago. I don't know. Nothing, I guess, is off limits. But we'll see how this plays out. I have a hard time believing Donald Trump is going to let this happen without some sort of fight. But yeah. $454 million is a lot of money.
Yeah, I'm confused. I've read it both ways. I don't know if he's the only way he can appeal is if he puts up the $454 million.
Yes.
Or is that the only way he can appeal?
Right. He's got to put the money up for first. The opportunity to appeal. Like, you got to pay to play, basically.
So dude, I'm reading here, he's actually got to post 120% of that amount, bringing the total to over $500 million.
Because there's interest every single day.
Yes, every day.
And really, this is just designed to break Donald Trump so he has less money in his pocket to run for president and humiliate him. It really is about the election.
It's politically motivated, no question. He would have never been charged with this ridiculousness if he wasn't running for president. I mean, you got to remember, Letitia James campaigned on, quote, getting Trump. And, you know, this leftist judge lunatic already said Trump was guilty of fraud before the trial was even over.
Right. It was the straight up Animal House trial that the Delta House had, where at one point I'm waiting for Donald Trump's lawyers to stand up. We don't think this is fair. And then the judge leans over like Dean Wormer. Let's end this damn thing. I mean, that's basically what happened here.
It is
here.
A kangaroo court, man. Wow.
A new polling shows that 2/3 of Americans believe that illegal immigration may be contributing to the violent crime problem in America. Donald Trump Jr., your thoughts?
No sh**. Who could have seen that coming? I had no idea.
This Rasmussen report polled about 1,200 likely voters between March 13th and the 17th and found that 66% said they are concerned that not vetting people as they walk across the border could lead to an uptick in crime.
Let me ask you a question. Why would people on the terrorist watch list, like, say, from Iran and Lebanon, and places like that, why would they want to break into this country? Because we have, there's been hundreds of people that have been on the terrorist watch list. Why would they, why do you think they'd want to come here? People that are specifically on the terrorist watch list, Hammer. Just.
I don't think it's for Cubs tickets. I'm just going to throw that out there. I don't think
it's scary.
It's for Chicago Cubs tickets. And think about this. Like last week, the big story was TikTok. TikTok ban. And everybody on Capitol Hill, Republicans and Democrats, they put on their Johnny Tough Guy suits and they were tough on China. This spyware app. How dare you put this on your phones? You want the Chinese spying on you? Meanwhile, every single day, Chinese nationals are just walking across the border.
Military-age men, yeah.
High-fiving people as they step into the country, and nobody says a damn word.
Now, there is a little bit of good news. Supreme Court just delivered a massive blow to Biden's open border policy. Ruled 6-3 that allows Texas to arrest and deport illegals. You know, basically asserting broad new authority, arguing the Constitution does, you know, allow the state to defend itself.
Right.
Imagine that. Imagine that the state, Governor Greg Abbott, actually allowed to deport illegals who cross illegally or criminals. I don't know, crazy notion.
And the fact that that wasn't a unanimous decision is disappointing. The fact you've got folks in Washington who feel like states should not have the right to protect themselves and defend themselves is a little disappointing. But this is kind of where we're at right now. And we're going to find out in November how many people want to side with doing the right thing and how many people want to side with, well, let's just keep doing what we're doing. Like, I'm curious. I really am.
Guess who one of the judges who dissented was?
Who's that?
Kajanji Drown Jackson, as Joe Biden calls her.
Fresh off her hot take of the First Amendment sucks, she comes out with this. Well, that's why Joe Biden wanted her there, right? That's why he pushed forward and was so hell-bent that she was part of that Supreme Court. Nige, with all of this crazy news going on, if you're looking for a reason to drink tonight, if you need a fun reason to crack one open...
Well, I was going to stay dry.
It's National Let's Laugh Day. National Let's Laugh Day.
That's why people listen to this show, mostly. They like to laugh.
We inform, but we also tell poop jokes. It's kind of how we get down, which is odd because Mike Pence used to sit in this chair, and his ratio to news to poop jokes was nowhere near what we do.
Is there a lot of laughing going on during Mike Pence's show? During his weekly radio show back in the day, you think?
I bet he would tell a horrible joke, and that ass-kissed Todd Meyer would probably have to act like he liked the joke. I hope he's listening
Todd
right
Meyer,
now.
Todd Meyer, legendary producer here.
One of the best.
Yeah.
So here's what we're going to do, Nige. I'm going to play a couple different laughs here. You tell me if you can identify whose laugh this is on National Let's Laugh Day, okay? Number one. Who's that?
That's a pantsuit Patty.
That's it. That's Hillary Clinton. One for one. All right, here we go. Number two.
What are you doing to me? I got it. Kamala.
Yes, two for two. Already we're doing better than the Kenny Chesney contest yesterday. All right, let's see if we can get a clean sweep here. It's National Let's Laugh Day, number three.
Can he play it again?
One more time.
I mean, it's Revenge of the Nerds. Do I have to be more specific than that?
It's okay.
Skolnick?
Yes, that's what I'm looking for.
All right, there we go. We got
it. That's what I'm looking for, because there were multiple people in the car, but mainly Lewis Skolnick's laugh. That was the scene where they were driving to Adams College and the old man's there, and Lewis and Gilbert are in the car.
Yeah.
And they're talking about the chicks, and the old man cracks a joke.
Yeah. That's fair.
Thank you. He's got to look at the roads.
All right, fellas. West Side eastbound, 70 crash at Harding. Right now, the left lane is blocked, and traffic's backed up for about a mile and a half. Looking at southbound 65, 2 downtown. Stop and go. 29th to Meridian Penn, Lawrence, northbound 465, slows from East 56 to 75th, and eastbound 465, stop and go traffic, Keystone Avenue over to Allisonville Road. Crash 10th at Elder Avenue. It's reported at the fire station involving a department vehicle. Also looking at eastbound 465 on the south side, stop and go from Kentucky Avenue to the White River. Traffic sponsored by Grand Appliance. Shop Grand Appliance for unbeatable deals like a mono washer starting at just $3.99. Forget the big box. Grand beats them every time. Visit GrandAppliance.com to learn more. I'm Matt Bear. Follow us for instant traffic updates at WIVC Traffic.
Don't forget, we have a merchandise store. store.hammerandnigel.com. Don't type in the www, it just makes things complicated. store.hammerandnigel.com. Hammer and Nigel t-shirts, hoodies, hat, pint glasses for beer sample Friday. You can get your I hate Rob Kendall t-shirt or your I love Rob Kendall t-shirt. A lot of stuff there. Check it out. We're adding more soon. store.hammerandnigel.com. It's 53 at the American Standard Heating Weather Center. Is This Anything is next.
Hey, quick question for you. When do you plan to file for Social Security? Because you got to be careful. You can set off a chain reaction of events with your taxes, IRA and 401k withdrawals, spousal benefits, and even your Medicare premiums, and it could needlessly cost you a small fortune. You got to learn how to avoid all this with analysis from Bill Demery, your retirement guy right here in Indy.
If you've saved more than $200,000 for retirement, but you've not yet filed for Social Security, schedule that free analysis right now. It's free by calling Bill Demery, 317-648-5120. It's free. And let's be honest, dealing with all this kind of stuff, it's incredibly complicated, but Bill Demery makes it easy. He breaks it down so you can understand it. Call him right now for that free analysis, 317-648-5120. 317-648-5120. Bill Demery, your retirement guy.
Did you know that April is Foot Health Awareness Month? Hi, this is Phoebe, and at the Good Feet Store, we think every month you should be aware of your foot health. Your feet support everything you do. Why wouldn't you want to properly support your feet in return? Foot health starts with having great support in your shoes, and with a selection of over 300 different styles and sizes of arch supports, we can help you get back to wearing your nice dress shoes, stylish flats, or even sandals in comfort. Listen to Ava's real Good Feet story.
I love shoes. You find them in the store, you know? They like call you, but they hurt. The best ones hurt the worst. And you're walking around going, I don't want anyone to know that I'm not happy, stuck in the arch supports, and I felt so much better. I'd say Good Feet help with all of my great shoes. They turned out to be something that actually works for me. My name is Ava, and that's my Good Feet story.
Don't overlook your feet. Make sure they get the care and attention they need so they can keep supporting you. Find the Good Feet store nearest you at goodfeet.com. We look forward to helping you find better foot health.
$5,000. That's the average amount of money people in the U.S. are now spending on gas in a year. $5,000. That's crazy. If you drive, you have to download Upside, the free app that gives you cash back every time you get gas. That's right. You can earn real cash back with Upside just by buying the gas you're already buying. You can literally start earning cash back today.
I use Upside every time I fill up, and top users make $200 to $300 per month.
You're putting gas in your car anyway. Why not get real cash back? If you
like free money? Download Upside.
I'm saving the cash I earn from using Upside to help pay for a vacation later this year.
Download the free Upside app now to earn cash back every time you buy gas. Use promo code STEER25 to get an extra 25 cents per gallon on your first tank. You can cash out anytime right to your bank, PayPal, or a gift card for Amazon and other brands. Just download the free Upside app and use promo code STEER25 for a 25 cents per gallon bonus on your first tank. That's code STEER25 for a 25 cents per gallon bonus.
Pizza's here.
Oh, great. I'd love some, but I'm worried about my stomach issues.
If you're worried about having diarrhea, gas, bloating, stomach pain, or loose, oily stools, it may not just be stomach issues. It could be a condition called exocrine pancreatic insufficiency, or EPI. With EPI, the pancreas doesn't release enough enzymes to break down food, but EPI is manageable. Use the symptom checker on identifyepi.com and talk to your doctor. That's identifyepi.com. Sponsored by AbbVie.
Oh, man, so Jay from Jay's Lobster and Fish Market there in the Garage Food Hall in the Bottle Works District downtown brought Hammer and I his brand-new hot honey fried lobster roll. Incredible. If you love lobster, you have to try this.
And also in the Garage Food Hall at the Bottle Works District, Palavana Cubano. And if you're looking for the best sandwich in Indy, the conversation begins and ends with the Cuban Reuben at Palavana Cubano. Tell them Hammer and Nigel sent you.
24/7 ER care for kids. 24/7 peace of mind for you. Riley Children's Health emergency doctors and nurses are in the ER around the clock at IU Health North in Carmel. Learn more at RileyChildrens.org/ER.
Hammer and Nigel presents. Is.
It depends upon what the meaning of the word is.
Yeah. Is this anything?
All right, let's rock and roll.
Hammer, how do we play? Is this anything?
I am going to run a couple different stories by you. You will be the one that breaks down all of the information and gives us a verdict. Is the story in question anything or not? Is this anything? There was an outdoor wedding taking place on a farm over in the UK when a cow happened to kind of walk by during the ceremony, and with the most perfect comedic timing of all time, when the officiant asks, "Does anyone object?" Take a listen.
In order to proceed, I must now ask if any person here present. Knows of any lawful impediment? Why they should not be joined in matrimony, you should declare it now. Non-bovine only.
Well, my question is, what was Joy Behar doing at the wedding?
Hi-oh! Wah, 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 wah! Hi-oh!
I saw the YouTube video of this. It's literally, they're literally on a farm. Now, they're and there's a fence. The cow's on the other side of the fence and moseys into the camera. I mean, they're taping this wedding, right? They want it on record. I guess I much would have rather have had the cow moo than take a big fat dump right in the camera angle. I mean, it was away from, but why?
Joy Behar would have.
So yeah, that's pretty funny. I mean, that's memorable, right? But who's having a wedding on a farm with cows walking around?
Oh, you'd be surprised, man. Like,
really?
Again, I've probably DJed close to 300 weddings in my life. Been doing it for a while. I'm finally retired. I'm out of the game now, but farm weddings, they're
really
a thing. They're
like with animals walking around?
Yep, I've seen it. And then you have the reception in like a barn. I've been there. I've DJed those a million times.
The barn, I know barn receptions, but they dress the barn up, right? It's a nice barn. It's not like stables and horse poop and things like that, right?
Correct.
Okay.
But, I mean, if you live on a farm and you want to get married there, you can't just kill all the animals because you're getting married. So I got to be honest, though. Every wedding that I've DJed, no matter who was getting married, whether it's friends, family, people I didn't know, I was always hoping something like that would happen.
What? That somebody would
object?
Do they even ask that anymore?
Yes.
So you've been to weddings where you remember they ask if anybody has any objection.
And the movies have taught me that happens all the time, but never. Never. The movies are so wrong about weddings. Nobody ever objected. There was never a jilted lover that tried to run in there last minute. Yeah. And maybe this is true in some cases, like wedding crashers. I never saw people trying to openly hook up at receptions because for the most part, everybody's kind of related now. So I don't know if I just didn't catch
it.
Or wedding crashing is very minimal. People hooking up at weddings that they don't know, very minimal. Didn't see a lot of that.
Okay.
Just my perspective. Is this anything? A Florida man on a motorcycle, rocking a sweet bitchin' mullet and sporting a license plate that read, "Will Run," was running from the police in a multi-city chase, hitting speeds of around 145.
Did you mention a mullet?
Yes. That's the part that floors you the most. He's doing 145 on a motorcycle. He's fleeing the police. And Nigel's like, whoa, he's got a mullet?
And it's a Florida man.
Take a listen to this. This is the end of the chase when police finally caught up with this guy and arrested him.
Somebody just tried to step out with him. He stopped at 2nd and Oak. 2 units making contact, 1 at gunpoint.
Oh, man, was that fun?
No, not really.
You see the tag? No, what's it say? I like to
run.
Yeah. Good job, man.
Yeah, I don't know how police officers, even with you know, as fast as those cars go, those patrol cars, I don't know how they catch the guys that are doing 145. How do you, I mean, you just must have to radio ahead to somebody that's in front of the motorcycle.
To try to slow him down a little bit?
I guess, because there's no way a Dodge, you know, what I drive, some Dodge Chargers, or those some of the police officers, kind of the manufacturer, the make and model of some of those police cars. I don't know how they catch up with those guys. I see it all the time on the road. The warmer it gets, man, these motorcycles weaving in and out of, I mean, they scare me to death. I mean, 145 ain't nothing.
145 is pretty hot. That's a lot of speed there. But you're right. Do you have somebody throw down like the stop sticks, or do you coordinate somebody to slow people down?
Exactly. Of course, if you do the stop sticks, you're gonna kill the guy.
Well, shouldn't have been doing 145. Okay. All of a sudden, this has turned into, am I a horrible person? The guy fleeing from the police doing 145. If he dies in the accident and I don't care, does that make me a horrible person?
I see two things. And I see a lot of guys in regular Dodge Chargers doing the same thing, like weaving in and out of traffic. I mean, who knows? I mean, they come right up on my tail, weave in and out. Truckers, you're my heroes. You guys are the heroes of COVID. But man, sometimes they do 80. They pass me going so fast. It's just, it's reckless. Come on.
Now, you're not doing 7, are you? Like, you're not Chris Farley doing 7 miles an hour.
Or like the nerd's dad. You know?
Papa Skolnick.
Yeah, Skolnick's dad doing 30.
Got the cruise control.
Set of 35. No, I'm not doing 7. I'm doing 55, 60, maybe a little over 60 in the right-hand lane as much as possible.
Okay.
That's me.
All right. Coming up next, we've got the president of the FOP. Rick Snyder is going to join us. I want to talk about this violent weekend in Broad Ripple. I want to get his perspective on everything playing out. We'll have that conversation. And then after that, we will have another round of Meltdown Madness. So we got a lot of stuff coming up. Do not go anywhere. This is the Hammer and Nigel Show.
Jefferson Shreve stepped up to fight when no one else would. He put it all on the line. And the liberals smeared him for it. With ads like this.
Donald Trump and Jefferson Shreve. He's an original supporter of Donald Trump.
They attacked Shreve for being a conservative.
Jefferson Shreve, an A rating from the NRA.
Attacked him for being a loyal Republican.
Look who was there, Jefferson Shreve. He was proud to be on the Trump campaign and proud of his own A rating from the NRA.
All because Shreve would get tough, back the blue, and stop the crime. But we don't have to accept their lawlessness at our border, in our suburbs, in our state. Because Jefferson Shreve is running for Congress, and he's a fighter for law, order, and a secure border. Jefferson Shreve for Congress.
I'm Jefferson Shreve, and I approve this message.
Paid for by Shreve for Congress.
Hi, this is Denny Smith. C&J is offering one of their great discount programs, and it's one you've got to take advantage of to upgrade your home's water system. Invest in one item, it's $250 off. Two items, $500 off. And if you invest in three items, you'll get $750 off. They're also offering $25 off a bacteria sampling, something you should be doing every year. Act now and make your water system goals for 2024 a reality with C&J. They're local and they're affordable. 317-733-SOFT or cnjwater.com.
Attention, Indiana homeowners. Are you tired of avoiding your wet basement? Hi, I'm Mike Smith with Swainco Crawl Space and Basement Repair, your real, local, Indiana family-owned experts. Imagine all the possibilities of a guaranteed dry basement, a cozy new family room, a home gym, or even a new office. And with no interest, no payment financing, you don't have to break the bank to do it. Make the most of your basement today. Call Swainco 317-407-1868 or swaincollc.com.
When life happens, Ms. Sheila's happens to help you through it. That includes water, storms, fire, and the whole insurance mess. Working hand in hand with the claims adjuster, Ms. Sheila's is your advocate, your voice, your local trusted advisor for cleaning up, building back, and moving forward when disaster strikes. Now that is an insurance policy. Make it Ms. Sheila's. Call 844-FIX-INDY.
93 WIPC Mobile News, on the level, on the go.
Why he's fired, 51 degrees and sunny at the Circle, nothing on radar, low of 38 tonight with more clear skies expected. I'm Harrison Silcox, here's what's trending at 431. A Henry County Corrections Officer accused of shooting an inmate with a pepper ball is out of a job. Henry County Sheriff John Sproul says it was all caught on camera.
The corrections officer, you know, told him to face the wall. I believe the inmate said, I am facing the effing wall. There was just a couple of back and forth, and they deployed the pepper ball round.
Former Officer Curtis Dowdy has a trial. It's scheduled for July. President Biden is in Nevada as part of a three-day campaign trip.
We're going to keep making the case for second term by lowering the cost and creating more jobs.
Biden won the state of Nevada during the last presidential election by more than 2% of the vote. He has stops planned in Arizona and Texas later this week. The House Foreign Affairs Committee is holding a hearing today over the withdrawal of troops from Afghanistan 3 years ago, where 13 U.S. service members were left behind and killed. Ranking member Democrat Gregory Meeks blames former President Donald Trump.
Former President Donald Trump's Doha deal empowered the Taliban at the expense of the Afghan government.
Republicans criticized the withdrawal in a report following an investigation. The White House said it was full of inaccurate characterizations. Wind gusts of 40 miles per hour are possible today. Greg Mello with the National Weather Service says secure any loose objects you may have outside.
Tomorrow the winds might not be so strong where that would be a concern. But yeah, for today, I would definitely recommend, you know, tying down any loose items outdoors.
He expects wind speeds to let up at least a little bit tomorrow. Stocks finishing up in the day. The Dow increasing by 320 points to 39,110. The NASDAQ also up by 63 at 16,166. And the S&P 500 increasing by 29 points to 5,178. You're 1 minute away from traffic and weather. It's 432.
With the weather changing, March is a critical time to check your home's windows. If yours are cracked or leaking and won't open or stay open, then it's time to call the pros at Window Nation. Right now, for every two windows you buy, you'll get two windows free. There's no limit to how much you could save. Plus, you could save even more with zero down, zero interest, and zero payments for 24 months. Window Nation's windows come with a lifetime warranty and can be installed in 1 day or less.
With proven quality service, it's no wonder thousands of homeowners have trusted Window Nation for their homes. And you can too. If your old windows and high energy costs from this past winter are cutting deep into your finances, don't miss out. With this unlimited deal, buy two, get two free, plus zero down, zero interest, and no payments for 24 months. You can't afford to wait. 866-90-NATION or go to windownation.com. Schedule your free in-home estimate.
With traffic at 4:33, here's Matt Baer.
All right, Harrison, we're in business. Eastbound 70 crash clear at Harding Street. Now the delay is made. We're already back to Holt Road for delay time. Well, it's only about 7 minutes since starting to thin out, so you should be on your feet here before too long. Southbound 65 is stop and go MLK to Meridian Pen. Hendricks County westbound 70 long delay starts well after State Road 267 runs from around 525 all the way out to State Road 39. I have it about 5 miles right now. Slow to stop traffic because of a road construction zone starting after State Road 39. That goes on until tomorrow night at 7 o'clock. Traffic sponsored by Drexel Interiors. Go where the pros go. Drexel Interiors for Timberlake Kitchen and Bath Cabinets. Visit Drexel's Design Centers at 146th Street and River Road or on North Shadeland online at drexelin.com. I'm Matt Bear. Follow us for instant traffic updates at WIBC Traffic.
And the forecast from the American Standard Heating Weather Center.
It's mostly clear and a little breezy for our Tuesday night with lows falling into the mid-30s. Then for Wednesday, still lots of sunshine around, but a little cooler with highs in the mid-upper 40s due to a breezy northwesterly wind and also dry as well. I'm Wish TV, StormTrack 8 meteorologist Stephen Deanna for 93 WIBC.
I'm Harrison Silcox on The Level on the Go and on WIBC.com.
You're listening to the Hammer and Nigel Show.
Hello, my name is Nigel. That's Jason Hammer right over there with a very special guest on the hotline.
Rick Snyder is the president of the Fraternal Order of Police, Lodge 86. He joins us now. Rick, we were talking earlier in the week about this chaotic weekend in Broad Ripple where not only was there a fatal shooting at a popular nightclub, there was also a stabbing. That was very serious. Just give us your thoughts on what you saw transpire in Broad Ripple this past weekend.
Well, I think it's another classic example of as the door turns. You know, we've been talking about this revolving door now for going on 4 years. And in Marion County in Indianapolis, not much has improved. It's a reality that's now setting in, I think, for people who have been watching this from afar. They're starting to see it play out in their own neighborhoods. And I think people are starting to come to the realization that we're starting to reap what's been sown by the local Indianapolis crime deniers and soft-on-crime advocates and enablers within our criminal justice system. You know, we had a shooter that was arrested with this mass shooting that occurred in Broad Ripple, and only to find out that this suspect, it appears, according to media reports, has prior convictions. Including prior convictions for felonies. So this was a prohibited possessor who was not lawfully in possession of a firearm to begin with. But it gets worse because we find out, according to the media, that he perhaps only served a little over a year for a prior felony burglary charge and then only 47 days for domestic-related strangulation that was a conviction after the prior felony. And so this guy is back out onto the streets, and now he's a suspect with multiple people shot and a person that's lost their life. You look at this other incident, you know, everybody wants to talk about guns, but as we have said, it's about shootings, stabbings, and other felonious attacks. You have a stabbing that occurs in which a female stabs another female two different times. And then in that, media reports say that the suspect appeared to be giddy and was asking, did she die? Well, when you dig into that one, you find out that this event occurred with that suspect out on another low bond that was radically reduced by the courts for a prior arrest and charge of criminal confinement with a deadly weapon. When you research that, you find that the initial bond was $40,000, drastically reduced, cut in half to $20,000, and then the suspect's back out on the street and paying less than $2,000. And so, guys, I just think it's another example of what we've been pointing to, and tragically, there are many lives that have been impacted by it.
So, Rick, who do we point the finger at for how these people keep getting out? Obviously, the prosecutor, it's Ryan Mears. He's the man in charge of prosecution in the county. But is this a situation where some of these judges have accepted sweetheart plea deals and offered things out there, and they're the ones that we should blame for this?
Well, obviously, when you look at the shooter that had a sweetheart plea deal in which multiple felony domestic-related charges were summarily dismissed based on the plea deal, and an alternative misdemeanor sentencing was made available on a strangulation charge, the number one lethality predictor for domestic-related violence, a judge does not have to accept that plea deal. They does not have to accept the terms of the plea agreement between the state, the prosecutor, and the defendant. And that's the role of the judges, to be a check and balance on that. So, again, I think local residents and taxpayers should be digging into these cases, asking the question, who were the judges that made these decisions, and looking for ways in terms of where does the accountability lie for that. I would also say, guys, take a look at the, you know, this is, again, multiple incidents of violence in the Broad Ripple area. And what we have said is there are ripple effects that affect the bottom line when it comes to allowing and a level of silence by our elected and appointed officials as it relates to the violence that's been occurring. It's no secret that's been happening in Broad Ripple. But I would ask you guys this question. Where are the gun-free zones that the Broad Ripple Village Association promised up there? You remember that when there was a mayor running for re-election and just before that was campaigning on how they were going to do these gun-free zones in cooperation with the local association? But guess what they found? It was exactly what we pointed out when we said we cannot, as law enforcement professionals, constitutional police officers, support or stand by such a program because it violates the Constitution. And guess what else those private associations and entities found out? They would absorb the liability that was involved when something tragic would occur. And as soon as their bottom line, their wallet was going to be threatened and impacted, they all pulled out of the arrangement. And now you have another failed promise and another political agenda that failed to produce.
Rick, something you have supported is some of the new technology that's being used to track these criminals. How important was that technology with the Broad Ripple shooter?
Well, it was the missing piece that actually solved the puzzle. First and foremost, it was solid police work. You know, as I've been saying, your police are not your problem. They continue to stand the line. They continue to do their jobs. Superior police work combined with the technology package that we called for all the way back in 2019 to be funded, which were additional public safety cameras and license plate reader technology, as well as these private cameras that private companies, businesses, and residents cooperated with police to help track these offenders. Don't forget, guys, we also called for a gunshot detection system for various parts of our city where critical infrastructure occurs and where mass gatherings are, and that still has yet to occur. So we're hopeful that will be the next piece to all of this. We don't know if it will be or not, but we're hopeful that it will be. But, guys, without a doubt, what we're finding is, even as important as the technology is, you must have the human being police officer, and as we know, we're losing those officers in droves in Indianapolis.
Rick Snyder is our guest. He is the president of the Fraternal Order of Police, Lodge 86. Rick, you bring up the shortage of officers here. There's also a new chief of police with IMPD. So when you factor in the officer shortage, what appears to be a prosecutor, mayor, and many judges apparently that are soft on crime, what kind of challenges are ahead for new chief of police, Chris Bailey?
Well, the deck is stacked against us. There's no doubt about that. The number one challenge that Chief Bailey is facing is the officer shortage combined with abysmal morale in the police department. We have more officers leaving than we can bring in. Guys, we are now 350 officers short. We're going to lose over 100 more officers this calendar year. And next month in April, we have a new recruit class coming on. Do you know how many officers we have in that recruit class?
No.
16. That's 1/6 for an agency that should be about 1,850 officers, and we're now down below 1,500 officers. Chief Bailey has said publicly that when we cross that threshold of going below 1,500 officers, whoever the chief of police would be forced to make decisions on reducing services available to residents. And listen, guys, that's not some kind of crazy conspiracy theory or something such as that. It's occurring all over our nation, here, near, and far. It's occurred in Pittsburgh, where they've cut back on the number of officers available in overnight hours. And people said, well, that's Pittsburgh. Well, now we learn in Washington County, Indiana, they have now stopped providing deputies on patrol overnight, during overnight hours when most crime will occur. And then here in IMPD in Indianapolis, we're looking at what services we're going to cut. Those are things like IMPD has already taken steps to get rid of their arson investigation unit with law enforcement officers. They have to look at other auxiliary programs such as our GREAT program, our Police Athletic League program, our Community Affairs program. Those are the first things that get cut when we start talking about a reduction in services. And I have to tell you, I believe that taxpayers expect and deserve the protection that they have paid for. But guys, here's the crux of this whole deal.
We've allowed folks to drive a wedge between the community and the police who serve them. And what we have actually seen is that when you drive the purpose out of policing, you drive the police out of the profession. And I would suggest to you that that is exactly what has occurred.
Do you feel like officers feel supported by leadership in Indianapolis and Marion County?
I think their biggest barometer of that is, quite frankly, we're in the process of starting the next negotiations for the next contract. Why is that important? People may say, well, that's just about the money. No, it's not. It actually shows what the sentiment is of our elected and appointed leader as it relates to our law enforcement officers. And it also tells them what they can expect at least over the next several years in Indianapolis. And when competition is as stiff as it is right now, where officers can go to any agency in the state or any other state and receive better pay, better benefits, and better equipment, it becomes an overwhelming concern. But listen, guys, we have to start tapping into the intangible as well, and that is the purpose for the police officer. G.K. Chesterton once said that the true soldier fights not because he hates what is in front of him, but because he loves what is behind him. That's the exact same thing that our officers face and why they do what they do. But that our city, our state, and quite frankly, our nation is starting to become overwhelmed by a sense of lawlessness. And as that increases, the Bible tells us the love of many will grow cold. And I would suggest to you that's what you're seeing in our cities, in our state, and in across our country. And something has to turn here, guys, before they it's too far away from us.
Rick Snyder, President, Fraternal Order of Police, Lodge 86. Rick, as always, we appreciate your time. God bless you, and tell your officers God bless. It's the Hammer and Nigel Show.
Offer, and you need to sell your home quick, but don't know what to do or who to call. I'll tell you who to call. Mark Deedle, the only real estate expert I trust and recommend with the sale of my home. How about Crystal in Franklin? She was moving to Kentucky, and she needed to move fast. She got Mark Deedle's marketing plan and was just blown away. And the plan worked. She got full list price in the first weekend. Just like that, Mark and his team got it done.
What separates Mark Deedle from the competition is the guarantee. Mark Deedle guarantees your home sold at a mutually agreed-upon price and deadline, or he will buy it. You pick the move date, no long-term contracts, no required repairs, and you can cancel at any time. Reach out to Mark Deedle today. Call him at 317-755-4232 or go to markdeedle.com. Mark D-I-E-T-E-L, markdeedle.com. Tell him Hammer and Nigel sent you.
You expect your home to protect everything you love, but you don't expect the ways water is breaking down your foundation and damaging your home. Cracks in walls and uneven floors are just a few signs your foundation is compromised. But there's one way to get answers to all your concerns. A free home inspection from Indiana Foundation Service. We put water back in its place. Get your free inspection at indianafoundation.com.
For over 75 years, Runnings stores have earned the reputation for quality brands, fair value, and hometown-friendly service. Now Runnings is bringing those same values to you. Runnings is now open in your community. Find the widest variety of everything you and your family need for your home, on the farm, and in the outdoors. Runnings is proud to live, work, and serve in local communities across the Midwest, the Northeast, and America's heartland. Runnings is your new home, farm, and outdoor store. We look forward to seeing you soon. Learn more about us at Runnings.com.
BoerRemodeling.com, serving Central Indiana for 23 years. These are your kitchen and bathroom remodeling specialists. When you're ready to make the change, they're ready for you. It's a new year, so it's time to get it done. That kitchen, that heart of the home, the bathroom, a place where you can actually relax and build instant equity in your home. 317-852-5546 or online at Boer, B-O-O-H-E-R, BoerRemodeling.com.
Pizza's here.
Oh, great. I'd love some, but I'm worried about my stomach issues.
If you're worried about having diarrhea, gas, bloating, stomach pain, or loose, oily stools, it may not just be stomach issues. It could be a condition called exocrine pancreatic insufficiency, or EPI. With EPI, the pancreas doesn't release enough enzymes to break down food, but EPI is manageable. Use the symptom checker on identifyepi.com and talk to your doctor. That's identifyepi.com. Sponsored by AbbVie.
Indy's leader in patio installation is now offering a new driveway package. Schedule a free estimate today at IndyDecorativeConcrete.com. That's IndyDecorativeConcrete.com.
Go where the pros go. Drexel Interiors for Timberlake Kitchen and Bath Cabinets. Visit Drexel's new design center on 146th Street at River Road or on North Shadeland. DrexelIN.com.
You want to listen all day to WIPC, but you don't always have time. Don't worry, there's a podcast for that. The WIPC Mashup. Daily highlights from your favorite hosts, Tony Katz, Kendall and Casey, and Hammer and Nigel. Subscribe wherever you get your podcasts.
All right, Matt Baer, he has a look at the roads.
Hammer westbound 70 Hendricks County stopped for miles beginning at 525 County Road, and then it goes on past State Road 39 to Hazelwood. It's about a 4.5 mile delay right now because of road construction. Right lane taken out, and that's going on until tomorrow night at 7:30. Inbound 69, stopping MLK 220. First eastbound 70, slow two downtown from the south split in Harding. Crash Speedway, Crawfordsville Road and Cunningham Road. Crash Beach Grove, Emerson Avenue north of Elmwood. And then in Lawrence, northbound 465, slows before Penn Pike up to 71st. Traffic sponsored by Drexel Interiors. Go where the pros go. Drexel Interiors for Timberlake Kitchen and Bath Cabinets. Visit Drexel's Design Centers at 146th Street and River Road or on North Shadeland. Online at DrexelIN.com. I'm Matt Baer. Follow us for instant traffic updates at WIBC Traffic.
Right now, we've got sunshine. We've got 53 at the American Standard Heating Weather Center. And we've got another matchup in Meltdown Madness.
Yeah!
You're listening to the Hammer and Nigel Show.
It's a well-oiled machine, baby. Meltdown Madness is presented by Window Nation. 866-90-NATION. Or go to windownation.com. Now, before we get into the latest Elite Eight matchup, let's recap what happened yesterday. Yesterday, we had a clash of the Titans.
Yes.
We had the number 10 seed, Tommy Lasorda, and his iconic rant against the San Diego Padres, and specifically one of their kind of journeyman players, role players, Kurt Bavakwa.
I have never, ever, since I've managed, ever told a pitcher to throw at anybody, nor will I ever. And if I ever did, I certainly wouldn't make him throw at a 130 hitter like a f***ing Bavakwa who could hit water if he fell out of a f***ing boat. And I guarantee you this, when I pitched and I was going to pitch against a f***ing team that had guys on it like Bavakwa, I sent a f***ing limousine to get the f***er to make sure he was in the motherfucking lineup.
That's strong.
I could listen to that all day, man, over and over and over again.
It was taking on one of the favorites in this tournament. The number 2 overall seed, friend of the show, Bill O'Reilly.
I can't do it. We'll do it live.
Okay. No.
We'll do it live. F*** it. Do it live. I'll write it and we'll do it live. F***ing thing sucks.
So, with, I think, a little help from the Kendall and Casey show.
You're kidding.
Because Rob's audience is all in on Tommy Lasorda by a final score. A 55.5% to 45.5%. Moving on to the final four, Tommy Lasorda.
When I pitched and I was going to pitch against a team that had guys on it like Bavakwa, I sent a limousine to get the to make sure he was in the motherfucking lineup.
Did you get that email from a listener, Ryan, who gave us more context and the backstory between that?
Right. So another player, Lefevre, was the one that was actually hit.
He was a third baseman.
Right.
And Bavakwa charged the mound and then later told reporters, as I thought, that it was Lasorda that had his pitcher throw at that third baseman. Crazy.
So Tommy Lasorda was probably thinking, okay, snitch, I'm going to just bury you to the media. So
Lasorda, the upset, a 10 over a 2 seed.
Yes. Moving on to the final four, which brings us to today's matchup. It's a 5 against the 13, okay? The number 5 seed. This is when radio legend Casey Kasem was recording his Top 40 program, and his producer, apparently, God bless this guy named Don, thought that he should be doing this sad, sappy dedication after a pretty fun, up-tempo song.
He was a little dog named Snuggles, but he was most certainly a part of... Let's go start again. From coming out of the record. Play the record, okay? Please. See, when you come out of those up-tempo damn numbers, man, it's impossible to make those transitions, and then you got to go into somebody dying. You know, they do this to me all the time. I don't know what the hell they do it for, but damn it, if we can't come out of a slow record, I don't understand it. Is Don on the phone? Okay. I want a damn concerted effort to come out of a record that isn't a f***ing up-tempo record every time I do a damn death dedication. Now, make it, and I also want to know what happened to the pictures I was supposed to see this week. Since the last damn time, I want somebody to use his f***ing brain to not come out of a damn record that is that's up-tempo, and I got to talk about a f***ing dog dying.
That's pretty good.
What, number five seed right there?
Right.
Okay.
Taking on a upset winner, the number 13 seed, ESPN host Chris Berman. This was during a commercial break of Monday Night Football pregame. And I guess during the previous segment, too many people were moving around.
When I'm doing TV and I got 18, God, can't everybody stop for 10 minutes? I mean, it's not that much to ask. Is that when everybody has to move, when I'm trying to concentrate? I mean, it's so rude. I can't believe it. It's so damn rude. Why does everyone all of a sudden have to move? I've had 2 hours to move around. Wait 10 minutes. It's like no one's ever worked on TV here before. I actually can't believe what I just saw. It's like no one here has worked on TV before. God.
So, Nige, what do you think?
Oh, man, that's so tough. I think it's going to be Casey Kasem for sure. But Chris Berman, I actually can't believe what I just saw. I've given up trying. I don't know. What do you think?
Yeah, I think Casey Kasem has probably got this one, but I've been wrong in this tournament before.
Because Casey Kasem is a slow build there, kind of right. Like Lasorda.
So, the poll is live right now.
Right.
Cast your vote at Hammer and Nigel on Twitter. We'll pin it to the top. Top stories next.
Look, if you think you're too busy to exercise and be healthy, you're wrong, okay? You're simply wrong. I felt that way when I started training and exercising like 6 or 7 years ago now. I show up once a week. It's a private 20-minute workout. It's helped me gain muscle. It's helped me get the physical exercise my body needs and craves. My clothes fit different now that I've been doing this. And plus, it's not like a big box gym atmosphere. It's a private studio. No mirrors, no music, no spandex. Just you and your coach. It's time to enjoy life and start feeling better. You'll be stronger and have more energy, just like I have. And again, it's a private once-a-week workout for 20 minutes. It's not an easy workout by any stretch of the imagination, but it's safe and it's effective. 5 locations, Avon, Brownsburg, Greenwood, Zionsville, and now in Fishers. Go to exerciseinc.com. That's exerciseinc.com. Change your life in 20 minutes a week with Exercise Inc. And tell Nigel sent you.
Congresswoman Sparks will be ready for your interview soon.
It seems pretty intense in there.
Yeah, kind of crazy. Maybe I'll take some time before the interview to Google Victoria Sparks and learn a little more about her. Whoa, have you seen this article?
One aide calling the lawmakers' workplace behavior manic?
Victoria Sparks was number one on Legistorm's list of worst bosses based on high turnover rates.
Says she, quote, avoided firing aides and instead bullied them until they left.
And the story is based on interviews with half a dozen former staffers.
Yikes. Sparks called staff morons and idiots.
Get this. Victoria Sparks says her working style is, quote, not for everyone.
Well, it's not for me. I think I'll pass on this interview.
I'm Chuck Goodrich. I'm running for Congress, and I approve this message.
Paid for by Go With Chuck Goodrich Committee.
Are you over 30 and putting off life insurance? It's time to get a quick quote from Ethos. A better, easier way to get term life insurance. All online with no medical exam. Answer a few health questions and you could be approved for up to $2 million. Isn't it worth 10 minutes to help protect your family's financial security? Ethos. Up to $2 million in coverage with no medical exam. Some policies as low as $1 a day. Answer a few health questions and get your free quote at checkethos.com. That's checkethos.com.
wealth-changing question. Has your advisor created a portfolio based only on your age and risk tolerance? That's simply not good enough. Your money deserves better, and so do you. At Creative Planning, our private wealth managers learn about you first, and then they create a customized plan and portfolio by partnering with our in-house money managers, accountants, and attorneys. Don't settle for a standard portfolio. Book your free meeting today at creativeplanning.com. Creative Planning, a richer way to wealth.
Jeff Lynn's ELO.
Mr. Blue Sky, please tell us why.
Live in concert in Indianapolis. The Over and Out Tour. Jeff Lynn's ELO. The final tour. All the hits. Live at Gainbridge Fieldhouse, Saturday, September 7th. Get tickets this Friday at 10 a.m. at Ticketmaster.com.
Coming up in 2 minutes, why strong winds and low humidity aren't a great combination. All that and more coming up after Fox News Radio from the Technology Recycler Studios. You're listening to 93 WIBC. WIBC HD1 Indianapolis. It's 5 o'clock.
The White House calls it unconstitutional. Elisa Brady, Fox News. After a Supreme Court win for Texas on immigration, the justices ruling 6-3 to lift a stay allowing enforcement of a new state law while a legal fight continues in lower courts.
The law makes entering the U.S. illegally, already a federal offense, a state crime, allowing police in the state to arrest and detain people believed to have illegally crossed the border. The U.S. Justice Department argues it's a violation of longstanding federal authority that could create chaos and hurt foreign relations.
Fox's Jared Halpern, and the Texas governor accuses the administration of failing to prevent what he calls an invasion of the southern border. The White House says today's ruling is another example of Republican officials politicizing the border and blocking solutions. Former President Trump just telling reporters,
"Our country is being invaded, and many of these people are criminals."
This after voting in the Florida primary and slamming President Biden.
"He's the worst president we've ever had, and I'm looking forward to November 5th.
A feeling that appears to be mutual.
"We're going
to
beat him again."
Yeah. President Biden campaigning in Nevada, where he also gives a speech on steps to lower housing costs before heading to Arizona, one of five states holding primaries today. The former Joint Chiefs chair says the State Department waited too long to order a non-combatant evacuation during the 2021 withdrawal from Afghanistan, which turned chaotic and ultimately deadly with a terror attack that killed 13 U.S. service members.
"The outcome in Afghanistan was the cumulative effect of many decisions over many years of war. And like any complex phenomena, there's no single causal factor that determined the outcome, but multiple factors in combination."
The now retired General Mark Milley tells a House hearing he had recommended keeping at least 2,500 troops there, but only until diplomatic conditions of a peace deal were met, and that it wasn't clear when or if those conditions would ever be met. America is listening to Fox News.
93 WIBC Mobile News. On the level. On the go.
Why there's a risk for fires. 51 degrees with clear skies over the monument. All clear with your radar. Low of 38 tonight. I'm Harrison Silcox for the Michaelis Corporation. Here's what's trending at 5:02. There's an elevated fire risk today because of strong winds and low humidity, says Greg Mello with the National Weather Service. You can expect more of the same tomorrow.
Tomorrow as well. Our wind gusts are going to be slightly lower tomorrow, anywhere from 20 to 30 miles per hour, but we'll still have, you know, low humidity values and even lower fuel moistures tomorrow as we dry out today.
Mello encourages you to secure any loose objects outside. An ex-Henry County jail officer is charged with battery
for shooting an inmate with the pepper ball. I'm Ryan Hedrick, and that's why Curtis Doty was charged, but that's not why he was fired.
When I reviewed the camera and was talking to my chief deputy, I said, just right off the bat, I mean, I can't deal with that type of language.
Henry County Sheriff John Sproul says he campaigned on treating everyone with dignity and respect, even those in jail. Matthew Flick, the inmate involved, is now considering suing Henry County. Ryan Hedrick, 93 WIBC Mobile News.
When the solar eclipse happens April 8th, you'll want to make sure you're wearing the proper eyewear if you plan to look at the eclipse.
But these are glasses that would have to be worn 100% of the time during the solar eclipse if they're going to be looking directly at the sun.
Dr. Sarah Olvey with Peyton Manning Children's Carmel Pediatrics says the glasses need to have ISO certification. You've probably heard of high schoolers getting early college credits. Donnie Burgess reports on a bill that could expand that kind of program.
Senator
Todd Young has teamed up with Democrat Senator Maggie Hassan for the Fast Track To and Through College Act. The bill would create a grant program to push students through early college credit programs. It would also create Pell Grants to cover the cost of dual credit classes for low-income students. Senator Young says the bill is all about making college more accessible and getting students started on the right path. Donnie Burgess, 93 WIBC Mobile News.
You're 1 minute away from traffic and weather. It's 5:04.
Michalis presents Password. The word is basement.
Okay. Wet.
Rain.
Leaky.
Faucet?
Stinky.
Socks.
Moldy?
Underwear.
What? Ugh, it's basement. Oh. Really? Moldy underwear?
Well, sometimes.
Ew. I did not need to know that.
Basement waterproofing and French drains. Life happens. Michalis happens to help you through it. Come on, take your basement back. 844-FIX-INDY.
With traffic at the 5s at 5:05, how's it going, Matt Bear?
All right, Harrison, let's go. In westbound 70 Hendricks County, stop traffic to stop and go. About a 4.5-mile delay. It starts well after State Road 267 runs past State Road 39. For a couple of miles. That's because of a work zone. And that's going on until tomorrow night until 7 o'clock p.m. Looking at northbound 465 stop and go on the northwest side, 86th Street to 865. Eastbound 465 drags Westfield Boulevard to Allisonville. Inbound 65 stop and go MMK to Meridian Penn. Eastbound 70 slow to downtown from Harding to Meridian, Illinois. South side, eastbound 465 slow 70 to the White River and again 31 over to Emerson Avenue. Crash Beach Grove. Emerson Avenue north of Elmwood Avenue lines out Emerson at Victory and a crash Crawfordsville Road at Cunningham Road. Traffic sponsored by Innovation Foundation Service, your trusted local experts. Your local experts for basement waterproofing, foundation, and crawl space repair. Book your free inspection at IndianaFoundation.com. I'm Matt Bear. Follow us for instant traffic updates at WIBC Traffic.
And the forecast from the American Standard Heating Weather Center.
We'll be mostly clear and a little breezy for our Tuesday night with lows falling into the mid-30s. Then for Wednesday, still lots of sunshine around, but a little cooler with highs in the mid-upper 40s due to a breezy northwesterly wind and also dry as well. I'm Wish TV StormTrack 8 meteorologist Stephen Deanna for 93 WIBC.
I'm Harrison Silcox on the Level on the Go and on WIBC.com.
Hammer and Nigel.
Can you believe these characters are weirdos?
So let's rock it!
My name is Hammer right over there with a surprise guest live in studio.
So we were talking a little bit earlier about the Carb Day concert. Miller Lite Carb Day. George Thorogood is the headliner. We've got Gin Blossoms. And here to tell us a little bit more is Doug Bowles from the Indianapolis Motor Speedway. Hey, Doug, how are you?
Good. Thanks for letting me just crash the party and bring a few beverages for us to enjoy on a Tuesday afternoon as we get ready for Miller Lite Carb Day.
Yeah, the 2024 Miller Lite Carb Day, Friday, May 24th. If you don't mind, I will. I was not expecting this at all.
No, right. and it's the Indianapolis Motor Speedway can, which is really cool. They do a special can for us every year. It's got our Indy 500 presented by Gainbridge logo on it, and it tastes like good beer to me. So it's
you could come by with beer anytime. Like, it doesn't have to be the day you announce Carb Day.
Well, I might
you
want
to swing by
I
in like
every day then
September. You know, come on by.
Yeah, absolutely. You know, there's never a bad time to have a beer and celebrate something for sure.
So tell us how this Carb Day concert came to be.
Well, this in some level is the most challenging day of the year for me because it's hard. A, you can't please everybody, right? And then B, when you're not a Live Nation venue, and I love our friends at Live Nation because they're helping us with our Legends Day concert with Riley Green the night before the 500. You have not a lot of leverage until all of the bands have figured out where they're going to go. And so you kind of sit around and wait, and then you try and figure out what makes the most sense. And we still, because Snake Pit on race day is so much about those young adults under the age of 30, we're still trying to hang on to those 80s. Folks that love the 80s music, and George Thorogood obviously has a lot of songs that we all remember from those days, and then Gin Blossoms was a little bit younger, and You know, I think we're kind of coming to the end of those 80s bands. We've had a bunch of them, so we may have to start getting a little bit younger on Carb Day. But it's a challenge just because of the way music works.
Right.
And because of, like, some bands have, like, in their contract, like, with the radius thing,
so it's not
right?
really the bands. It's the promoter that has the radius clause. So we'll have one in our agreement. And, for example, this is a great example of how Hoosiers work together to help Hoosiers. Our friends in Nashville actually have George Thorogood ahead of us. And when we offered George Thorogood an opportunity to play, he said, you know, I can't. I've got a radius clause issue in Nashville, Indiana. So we worked with the promoter down there. They were fantastic. They said, look, we're happy to let this one go because we know how important Carb Day is in the Indianapolis 500.
Oh, wow.
But they just asked that we not make the announcement until after March 11th, which gave them time to get tickets sold and to really promote their event. But most people that you deal with, the radius clause oftentimes can be up to 150 miles. If even at 100 miles, it pushes us into Louisville, Cincinnati. You start thinking about other markets. Who could care less about Indiana? So you don't have the ability to call a promoter like Christian down in Nashville and say, hey, can you help us out so we can get George Thorogood here on Carb Day?
We were talking earlier, you know, singing your praises, not knowing you were going to come by the show.
Well, my wife called me and told me you were, so I felt safe coming in, so that was good.
But you've got something for a little bit of everybody, right? So the young folks are going to go on race day and have a good time at the Snake Pit with the techno DJs. You're going to have folks like Nige and I that love Carb Day, those 80s kind of hair band, rocker bands. Now we're getting a little Gen X-y with like Gin Blossoms, the country concert on Legends Day.
Yep.
That's all, you know, part of the plan, right? Getting as many groups of people to the track as possible.
For sure. You want to give something for everybody. And the hardest part with Carb Day is a mix of everybody, right? So when you pick just one genre, you ultimately get a handful of people that are like, hey, why didn't you do X, Y, or Z? But you're right. The Snake Pit and our friends at Miller actually through their Coors brand are supportive of us there. That's 25,000 young adults under the age of 30 that come to the Indianapolis 500 and don't watch the race. And I'll get old timers that say to me, why do you care about people that don't watch the race? Because I know who they are, and ultimately, and we're seeing it, as they grow up, they go, you know what, I'm not going to spend my whole day down there in the mosh pit. I'm going to go down for the two or three artists I like, and then I'm going to buy a grandstand seat because this is what I do on Memorial Day Sunday, and we're actually converting those folks to race fans.
That's what Allison and I were talking about earlier. Is there any sort of numbers or reports that, you know, since you guys have been doing
for
this,
and
it's been a long time, those folks also are being transcended into race fans?
For sure. So we've got hundreds of people who have transferred. It's more anecdotal beyond that in terms of, I'll talk to somebody my age, I'm 57, who'll say, you know what, thanks for doing the Snake Pit, because now my kid, who used to come with me when he was a kid, brings his college buddies and they go to the Snake Pit, but at least they continue to come every year. And then you hear from parents who say, you know, now they're back in the seats with us again, and their friends who'd never been before but for the Snake Pit got there. I can tell you, if we go on a college campus and you put an IndyCar and you take Tony Kanaan, people walk right by. If you have an IndyCar and Tony Kanaan and a billboard of all the EDM artists, people stop and ask, hey, where is that? I want to go. What's it about? And it's an opportunity to see the speedweights. Same reason we're doing the Eclipse viewing event. So we're going to have 30 to 40,000 people at the Speedway on April 8th, 75% of whom have never purchased something from the Speedway in their life. So it's a great way for us to introduce them to our brand and get them going forward. So it's all a balancing act as we start trying to figure out how do you build that next customer.
Whose input do you get on your staff for the EDM artist? I'm wondering, because you don't strike me, Doug, as, I'm sorry, you strike me more as a George Thorogood guy.
No, you're right. That's fair.
Like
that's,
who? That's, like, I understand.
You mean he doesn't have the marshmallow hat at home?
Yeah.
Do you have a staff? Do you have a work with consultants on who to find for this that
so
event?
We have a great consultant who really builds our stage and does our production, and he's Dead Mouse's manager. So he's in that space. So he's really great. My stepson's Connor Daly. Connor Daly absolutely loves EDM music, so he's a great resource. A couple of my kids are good resources. There are young folks in the organization. Bud Danker, who's the president of Penske Corp., his kids are into EDM, so as we start going through this, we sort of have a whole group of people that we talk to, and then I try and memorize the names because I have no idea what they sing. Although I will tell you, I'm super excited for Timmy Trumpet to be one of the players. So if you're familiar with the Alex Rodriguez walkout music, if just Google that, millions of people have watched it. The guy plays a trumpet, and he's EDM music, and he's going to be part of the Indy 500 for the Snake Pit. I don't know if we've announced this, so this may be my PR team's probably mad. I'm about to say this. But Timmy Trumpet is going to do our walkout music for the drivers in the driver intro. So it's going to so a way to tie that in with some of our youth, I think, is going to be very cool. So as we continue to work with that, it's just you got to trust the people who are younger, because I'm certainly certainly not in that demo.
Look up the closer video for the Mets. That's like his music. You hear that trumpet. He runs out of the bullpen like a boss. So I know exactly what you're going for here. That's going to be really cool.
Yep.
Ticket sales sound like they've been really, really good.
The 500 has just continued to be healthy, and people always and get better. People say, what do you account that for? And the first thing I say is fans who are super passionate about the Indy 500. The best sales tool we have is a fan who invites what they call a rookie. I have so many people say, I've got three rookies coming. I've got that bring somebody along, because the best way to experience the Indy 500 is with that Sherpa, with that racing Sherpa that can walk you through it. So that's part of it. I think the other thing is, I think our fans realize that they have a steward in Roger Penske who loves the Speedway like they do. He's invested about $60 million in the Speedway since he's purchased it. Almost all of it is around the customer experience. So I think when people feel like the people that own the Speedway have a lot of pride in the Speedway and are like they are, I think that helps us too. So there's a whole bunch of reasons. And the racing's been fantastic. Joseph Newgarden.
Last year was amazing. We had guests. We sat in the Penthouse Pagoda with the awning. Is that what it is? Yep. The Penthouse Pagoda? And we had family friends in from England who had never been. And we got there early and stayed late for the entire thing, took the bus route home.
Yep.
They were just blown away. And so was I, quite frankly, because I haven't been in a couple of years. And we had those seats are awesome.
And when you're in the Paddock Penthouse, it's an amazing place to view. I call 10 customers every night just to say, hey, thanks for being an Indy 500 customer. We don't get to celebrate the Indy 500 68 days without you. And when you get a chance to talk to them, what's cool is our customer, no matter where they sit, think they have the best seat in the house.
Yes.
The turn two folks, a three, four, doesn't matter, because of the memories you create there. And that's one of the things that I think Roger's learned since he's bought the Speedway, is that it's not just about the racing. It's about all the other things that take place. Where you park, whose yard you park in, what you put in your cooler, who sits around you. I mean, all those things are part of the experience. I talked to a guy who was visiting a few years ago in 2021, and he came out for practice, and he said, well, I live near Daytona. Somebody said this is kind of like the Daytona 500, so I came out, and he said, you know what, it is kind of like the Daytona 500. I said, well, you ought to come back and see the 500, and thanked him, and I walked away. I thought, it's not like the Daytona 500. We're not the Daytona 500. If you're going to compare us to another race, it's Le Mans, it's Monaco. We're an event. The Daytona 500 is a great race, but it's not the event that the Indianapolis 500 is, and that's what, when you bring people and they look around, they go, it's the second largest city in the Indianapolis Motor Speedway on race day inside the track.
Incredible.
It's pretty incredible.
And it just means so much to so many people. And I think I fall into that category. You know, I've told my kids, you know, when my time on this earth is done, you know, cremate me, and I want some of my ashes somewhere at the Indianapolis Motor Speedway.
Okay, let me just say, there's a state law that we are not a cemetery, so do not call me and ask me.
It's happening. I'm just telling you happening.
And I'm just telling you, do not call me and ask me if you can do it, because I have to tell you no. It happens all the time, right? But don't call me, because I'll give you the answer you don't want. Just sneak out and just...
Right.
You know, the mini marathon last year, I didn't run it last year. I chickened out. I'll run it this year. And I was standing at the start-finish line, and the next thing I know, I watch, and somebody goes by, and you look along the yard of bricks, and there's this row of ashes, and you know exactly what somebody did. And then I felt sorry for the people who were walking through and decided they wanted to kiss the bricks. I'm like,
Yeah, there's going to be a little bit of me somewhere in the Bellagio fountain, and there's going to be a little bit of me at the Indianapolis Motor Speedway.
Just don't ask me.
Maybe Wrigley Field, too. I don't know. Depends on how much of me there is. All right, so if somebody wants to get tickets to Carb Day or the Indianapolis 500, Doug, what's the easiest way to do that?
Easiest way is just to go on IMS.com and do that. And if you want to talk to a live ticketing person that really is at the Indianapolis Motor Speedway and cares about you, you can always call the Indianapolis Motor Speedway, 317-492-8500. But IMS.com is really the best way to do it. You can go on there, and you can pick the seat you want, and you can see what the view is from your seat. I will tell you that we are running out of reserve seats quickly, so if you want them, you should get them soon.
Awesome. Doug Bowles with the Indianapolis Motor Speedway.
Thanks, Doug,
you're the best. Thank you.
Thanks for having me, guys.
All right, Matt Baer standing by in the WIBC Traffic Center. He has a look at the roads.
All right, Hammer, watch out Ohio Street at East Street downtown. Police activity there. And then northbound 465 on the east side. Stop and go traffic after 70 up to 71st. Inbound 65 to downtown. Slow MLK to Meridian. Meridian Pad and eastbound 70 drags from Harding to Meridian, Illinois. Hendricks County westbound 70 has a bad delay stretching about 5 miles now as we look at what's after State Road 267 on westbound 70 going west towards Terre Haute. And we have stop and go traffic after 267 for 5 miles past 39 because of road construction going on until tomorrow night. Traffic sponsored by Robert Half. 9 out of 10 hiring managers are having difficulty hiring today. Robert Half is here to help. At Robert Half, they know talent. Visit RobertHalf.com today. I'm Matt Bear. Follow us for instant traffic updates at WIBC Traffic.
Get your votes in for Meltdown Madness, presented by Window Nation. It's pinned to the top of our Twitter account, at Hammer and Nigel. Casey Kasem against Chris Berman. Right now, Casey Kasem, big lead. So, we'll see if that holds up until tomorrow. Right now, we got sunshine. Monument Circle looks beautiful. It's 53 at the American Standard Heating Weather Center. And we'll play a round of Are You Okay With This next.
Jefferson Shreve stepped up to fight when no one else would. He put it all on the line. And the liberals smeared him for it with ads like this.
Donald Trump and Jefferson Shreve. He's an original supporter of Donald Trump.
They attacked Shreve for being a conservative.
Jefferson Shreve, an A rating from the NRA.
Attacked him for being a loyal Republican.
Look who was there, Jefferson Shreve. He was proud to be on the Trump campaign and proud of his own A rating from the NRA.
All because Shreve would get tough, back the blue, and stop the crime. But we don't have to accept their lawlessness at our border, in our suburbs, in our state. Because Jefferson Shreve is running for Congress, and he's a fighter for law, order, and a secure border. Jefferson Shreve for Congress.
I'm Jefferson Shreve, and I approve this message.
Paid for by Shreve for Congress.
Listen, if you're within a few years of filing for Social Security, you need to listen up here. Be careful. You can set off a chain reaction of events with your taxes, IRA, 401k withdrawals, spousal benefits, and even your Medicare premiums, and it could needlessly cost you a small fortune. But you could learn how to avoid all that with a free customized Social Security analysis from Bill Demery. He's a retirement guy right here in Indy.
If you've saved more than $200,000 for retirement, but you've not yet filed for Social Security, schedule that free analysis right now. It's free by calling Bill Demery, 317-648-5120. Dealing with all this kind of stuff, it's incredibly complicated, but Bill Demery makes it easy. Call him right now for that free analysis, 317-648-5120. 317-648-5120. Bill Demery, your retirement guy.
Tony Katz here, and if you know me, you know I like my bourbon, and just like you, I like a good deal. So let me tell you about Hotel Tango Bourbon. Hotel Tango is a distillery right here in Indianapolis, started by Travis Barnes, a Marine who served 3 tours in Iraq. He wanted to craft spirits with the same discipline he learned in the Marine Corps. That's what Hotel Tango does. I've tried his bourbon. It's wonderful. It's a 4-grain bourbon with a distinct mash bill. You get a little caramel, some of that aroma. You get a nice rye kick to balance it out. I'm not the only one who thinks it's good. Wine Enthusiast gave it a 94 and it won a gold at the San Francisco Spirits Competition. It's also under $40. Did I mention that? One of the 10 best bourbons under $40 according to Wine Enthusiast. Try it for yourself. Head down to wherever you buy fine spirits and try Hotel Tango for yourself. You'll be supporting local, supporting veterans, and getting yourself a great, sippable, enjoyable bourbon at a great price. Thanks to Hotel Tango for sponsoring the show. Hotel Tango, distilled with discipline. HotelTangoDistillery.com.
Everyone wants energy that's reliable and affordable. I've been a Duke Energy line worker here in Indiana for almost 20 years. So I'm proud to help deliver that for the people and the communities that matter most to me. With stronger, more resilient systems, better able to stand up to severe weather, and support for local businesses and jobs. It feels good knowing I'm helping build a smarter energy future for all of us.
Paid for by Duke Energy shareholders.
Life insurance. Why are you putting it off? Can't afford it? Too much hassle? Think you don't need it? There's lots of excuses for putting off life insurance. But if you weren't there, who would pay the mortgage and other bills? With Ethos, you could be covered in 10 minutes and boom, family protected. Ethos, fast and easy online term life insurance. Up to $2 million in coverage with no medical exam. Some policies as low as a dollar a day. Answer a few health questions and get your free quote at getethos.com. That's getethos.com.
Inside Indiana Business Radio, the news you need to get ahead. Indiana's business news leader, weekdays at 6:32 a.m. and 5:56 p.m. on WIBC.
Go where the pros go. Drexel Interiors for Timberlake Kitchen and Bath Cabinets. Visit Drexel's new design center on 146th Street at River Road or on North Shadeland. DrexelIN.com.
What if the next time you painted your home was the last time you painted your home?
Our home has had Rhino Shield for 10 years.
Rhino Shield. Call 888-RHINO-41. Don't paint, don't vinyl. Go Rhino!
Okay, let's begin.
Are you really okay with this?
Are you okay?
Everything's gonna be okay.
Are you okay?
Are you okay?
Yeah, I'm fine.
I'm pretty f***ing far from okay.
Whoa. Are you okay with this?
On the Hammer and Nigel Show.
Oh, this is fun. Hammer, do you want to hear a real short version of John Mellencamp's Jack and Diane Live?
Real short?
Yeah, he was doing a show Sunday night in Toledo, Ohio. He stopped the show to tell a story about his grandma or something.
Which is always great for a concert when you're ready to rock.
An impatient heckler called out for more rock, less talk. And it turns out, as we all know, Mellencamp's patience is even shorter. He calls the guy you're not allowed to call this to an umpire in baseball, as we learned.
Okay, I know what you're talking about.
He calls this guy and asks the roadie to find the guy for after the show.
And she went, "It's just like you, buddy, to be a smart aleck when I'm talking to Jesus." And then it got real quiet.
Play some music.
What do you think I mean, Jimmy?
That's right. There it is.
Hey, Joe, find this guy and let me see him after the show. Anyway, before I was so rudely interrupted. Guys, I can stop this show right now and just go home. Since you've been so wonderful, I'm going to cut about 10 songs out of the show. Here we go. A little ditty. Now Jack and Diane. The magic kids go in our land. You know what? Show's over.
Are you okay with everything you just heard right there, and then John Mellencamp, after being heckled, saying, "Show's over."
You know who I'm okay with? The guy that yelled out, "Play some music!" Like, come on, John, I get it. Every artist wants to talk on the stage. But, like, when I was growing up, every rock radio station, or even any pop music radio station, their slogan was, "Less talk, more rock."
Yeah.
That's what you want.
Yes.
Like, shut the hell up about your grandma. Like, I get it. Everybody here, you know, they grew up listening to your songs. We appreciate what you're doing. But just play your hits. We don't want to hear about your grandma, John.
I bet there's a lot of political stuff. I don't know for sure. I haven't been doing a show in a long time. Last show I went to, John Mellencamp, he did, like, some melody of all his hits.
Oh, isn't that,
like,
the worst?
And then he did, like, a lounge act where he sang lounge songs.
Oh, no, that's the worst.
So
Prince used to do that, too.
You know what
I
mean?
Like a little medley of hits and a bunch of crap.
Very anti-Republican, anti-conservative, anti-Trump, anti-everything you could think of.
He's very pro-smoking.
Yes.
Hot damn, he is pro-smoking. So, yeah, I mean, come on. These people paid money to you to be there. Don't be a putz at the end just because somebody actually wants to hear Jack and Diane.
He had like 9 or 10 songs ago, he said, and just left.
So here's what we're going to do on the Hammer and Nigel show. We're going to play you a much better version of Mellencamp's Jack and Diane.
Sucking on a chili dog. Sucking on a chili dog. Sucking on a chili dog.
Sucking on a chili dog.
Sucking on a chili dog. Sucking on a chili dog. Sucking on a chili dog.
Sucking on a chili dog.
Come on.
Sucking on a chili dog.
Everybody.
Yes, all the lyrics were sucking on a chili dog.
All right, this could have been booze news, but I figured we'll put it in. Are you okay with this? Pizza-flavored beer arrives next month. Let me repeat that. Pizza-flavored beer arriving next month. The New Belgium partnered with the frozen pizza brand Tombstone for it. New Belgium sells the brand Voodoo Ranger, which I drink a lot. It's an IPA. It's an IPA that's 7% alcohol, but
okay.
It's pizza beer. Are you okay with pizza beer?
I like pizza. I like beer. Hell yeah, I'm okay with this. I'm all in,
yeah.
Baby. I am here for this, and I'm not even a big IPA guy. Like, I'm a cheap Southside domestic beer guy. I love a Miller Lite. I love a Coors Light. Somebody pass me a PBR.
Yep.
I can sit in the bleachers at Wrigley and drink an Old Style. That's who I am. But if you're going to tell me you're going to mix something with pizza, and listen, say what you want about Tombstone. I've had my fair share of a Tombstone frozen pizza.
Sure.
I am here for that. Yes, this is something. All right, here's what we're going to do. It's kind of become a Tuesday tradition around here. We're going to play a round of caller roulette.
Oh, no.
This is where you call into the show at 239-9393, and you can bring up any subject that you want as long as it's radio-friendly and you keep it clean, okay? Allison, make sure you've got the dump button ready, because that's been an issue with us before. But whatever you want to talk about, if you want to talk about Trump or the governor's race, we can do that. If you want to talk about
John Mellencamp leaving the stage early in the middle of the show,
or March Madness, you can do that. If you want to hit on Matt Bear or Allison, you can do that. Whatever you want, let us know. We'll take the calls blindly. Okay? Again, just keep it clean and keep it brief. 239-9393. We don't take a lot of calls on this show, but when we do caller roulette, let's go big or go home. 239-9393. Your calls right after the news with Harrison Silcox.
93 WIPC Mobile News. On the level. On the go.
Where he says the problem lies. Sunny skies and 53 degrees downtown. No rain at your radar. Low temperatures expected to drop just below 40 tonight. I'm Harrison Silcox. Here's what's trending at 5:30. A woman has been charged with attempted murder, accused of stabbing her girlfriend in Broad Ripple. Donnie Burgess reports one local police leader blames the courts.
Indy Fraternal Order of Police President Rick Snyder.
This event occurred with that suspect out on another low bond that was radically reduced by the courts for a prior arrest and charge of criminal confinement with a deadly weapon.
Snyder on WIBC's Hammer and Nigel. Police say Taniqua Hurd happily asked, did she die as she was being arrested for the stabbing? That kind of person, along with accused mass shooter Nicholas Folk, shouldn't be on the streets due to their criminal past.
I just think it's another example of what we've been pointing to, and tragically there are many lives that have been impacted by it.
Donnie Burgess, 93 WIBC Mobile News.
President Biden is criticizing former President Trump's tax cuts while campaigning in Nevada.
Trump passed the tax cut. Here's what he said. He said in Mar-a-Lago, when he passed his last tax cut, which increased the deficit, exploded the deficit larger than any president ever has in a four-year term. Here's what he said. He said, I made a lot of you richer.
Biden's stop in Nevada today is part of a three-day campaign trip. He'll be in Arizona and Texas later this week. A Supreme Court win for Texas. Fox's Nate Foy explains.
This Supreme Court ruling allows Texas to implement SB 4, which allows them to possibly deport migrants who cross the border illegally without turning them over to Border Patrol. So essentially how it would work is they would have to see a migrant crossing illegally, and then they could just charge that migrant with criminal trespassing, take them to a judge who then would give the migrant the option to go back to Mexico or go through the court process and be charged with that crime.
The Biden administration says Texas is interfering with the federal government's immigration policies. When the solar eclipse happens April 8th, you'll want to make sure you're wearing the proper eyewear if you plan to look at the eclipse.
But these are glasses that would have to be worn 100% of the time during the solar eclipse if they're going to be looking directly at the sun.
Dr. Sarah Olvey with Peyton Manning Children's Carmel Pediatrics says the glasses need to have ISO certification, which you can find on the inside of the left arm of the glasses. And with traffic at 5:32, here's Matt Baer.
All right, Harrison, Hendricks County westbound 70 is stopped for about 5.5 miles because of road construction. This is westbound 70. If you pass State Road 267 exit, you'll be in it. Again, 5.5 miles past State Road 39, all because of construction going on until tomorrow night. Downtown, gunshots reported Ohio Street at East Street. There could be police activity there right now. These shots are unconfirmed. Southbound 65, stop and go traffic before MLK to Meridian Penn. Eastbound 70 slows from Belmont Avenue to the south split in Macon North. You'll be slow up to the Washington Street exit. Northwest side, northbound 465, stop and go 86 to 865. Eastbound 465, dragging from Westfield Boulevard to Allisonville Road. Ed and Lawrence, northbound 465, stop and go 70 up to Penn Pike. Traffic sponsored by Drexel Interiors. Go where the pros go. Drexel Interiors for Timberlake Kitchen and Bath Cabinets. Visit Drexel's Design Centers at 146th Street and River Road or on North Shadeland. Online at DrexelIN.com. I'm Matt Baer. Follow us for instant traffic updates at WIBC Traffic.
And the forecast from the American Standard Heating Weather Center.
We'll be mostly clear and a little breezy for our Tuesday night with lows falling into the mid-30s. Then for Wednesday, still lots of sunshine around, but a little cooler with highs in the mid-upper 40s due to a breezy northwesterly wind and also dry as well. I'm Wish TV StormTrack 8 meteorologist Stephen Deanna for 93 WIBC.
I'm Harrison Silcox on the Level on the Go and on WIBC.com.
Buckle up. Anything can happen here.
Oh, hell yeah. Let it ride. Let it ride.
Hammer and Nigel present Caller Roulette.
Oh, man.
Let's go.
Anything can happen here. All we ask, you keep it clean, you keep it brief, and we'll see what can happen. Now, before we get to this, Nige, tweet came in from some sort of insurance agent at Hammer and Nigel.
Okay.
I can't get through, but my question is, how come you guys get a lot of time off?
I get a lot of time off because I take a lot of time off.
How very Patrick Ewing of you.
No, it's the opposite. I take a lot of time off, but I get a lot of time off.
Right. We contracted for it. Yeah. They gave it to us, and we get paid for it. You would do the exact same thing. So let's rock and roll. Chadwick, welcome to the Hammer and Nigel Show. What do you want to talk about?
Hey, just want to say I love you guys. I love the yin and yang you got going on there. Nigel, say your good, sensitive stomach, sweet self. I kind of wish the traffic was a little more Hunger Game-ish, like may the odds ever be in your favor. I've got to drive from Ellettsville to Indianapolis, and I've been doing it in 69. We'll never be done. We've just accepted it. It's just a fact of life. So we've got 800,000 people. We've got 6 working roads. Good luck.
Thank you, Chadwick.
Referring to my weak stomach there.
Yes. Yeah. And he's right. That 69 will never be done.
Oh, my gosh.
And Rockville Road will never be done. That thing has been under construction since I got my driver's license in 1994. Jim, welcome to the Hammer and Nigel Show. What do you want to talk about?
You guys do a great job. I'm just really disappointed that Indiana State University is not the NCAA. I understand the tourney to get you in automatically. But am I to understand that IU declined the NIT as well?
Yes. Indiana said they would not be interested in playing in the NIT. Coach Woodson and the athletic department said they'd rather take that time to go hit the transfer portal, recruit that, and do recruiting stuff.
You should have seen JMV in the back office yesterday after his Sycamores weren't picked to go in. Boy, he was on fire.
I didn't have the heart to tell him that I thought it was the right decision. I didn't want to hurt him anymore.
You can't say that to him.
I know. Chris, welcome to the Hammer and Nigel Show. We're doing Caller Roulette. What do you want to talk about?
Kenny, Denny, and Benny. I think y'all need to get that young lady back on the phone and I think that was a little too hard for her. Maybe give her the choice of Kenny Chesney, Kenny Rogers, and Kenny G.
Now, that's a great idea. Now, the voice of reason on this show is Allison. So, Allison, let me bring you on the microphone here. Do you think the game we played yesterday was too hard?
We try so hard to make it easy. And and you even read the last one with, like, hints of a guy in England. You know, you were giving all the hints in right. the question. We were really trying, but there's only so much we can do.
So yesterday we played Kenny, Benny, or Denny for a chance to win tickets to go see Kenny Chesney.
Yeah.
And I explained this as, I'm going to give you a fact. It will either be a fact about country music star Kenny Chesney, English comedian and TV host Benny Hill, or NASCAR driver Denny Hamlin. And bless her heart, yeah, the
know.
Contestant lost 2 out of 3.
And maybe. One of them she lost was the Kenny Chesney song.
Yes.
For the Kenny Chesney
Even tickets. If you don't know who Benny Hill was.
I said, this person often signed off on his TV show where he's running around the English countryside with Yakety Sax playing in the background. The context clues were there. And I will not apologize for that contest. As a matter of fact, we might even do it again here coming up. Bill, welcome to the Hammer and Nigel show. Bill, how are you?
I'm doing all right. How you fellas doing?
Awesome.
Well, I really enjoy your show. Crack me up and entertain the hell out of me. I got an idea for your merch store.
Okay.
It's borderline inappropriate, so it should fit just perfect.
Allison,
get ready. What do we got here, Bill?
All right. Now, Rob Kendall has a couple, I'm sure, very successful T-shirts on there. And I think Casey deserves a little bit of credit herself. So I suggest you do a T-shirt with one of those legendary supposed bikini shots of her with the caption reading, Casey Daniels, my favorite side piece.
Okay. That's good.
Because that's her blog that she writes on WIBC.com.
Right. The side piece. Yes.
I just don't know that she would consent to putting her image on one of our shirts.
Maybe we could go without the image, but just say Casey Daniels is my side piece.
I like it.
Okay.
I like it.
store.hammerandnigel.com. That's our merchandise store. Get your Hammer and Nigel gear. You can also buy an I hate or I love Rob Kendall t-shirt. Let's go to Ryan. Ryan, we're doing caller roulette. What do you want to talk about?
Hey, Hammer, I just wanted to pull the mask off you guys so that everybody knows that you really are never a horrible person. Rob Kendall is one of the nicest men that I've ever met. And this is Farmer Ryan.
Ryan, there you go.
I just really appreciate you all so much and listen to you every day. And Samuel, my son, goes in. He's going to be in the hospital for 140 days.
Oh, no.
Yeah, I knew about your son's health, and we're praying for you, Ryan.
Yeah, man, God is good all the time, and we're praying for you, absolutely.
Thank you, and I really do like that idea about Casey Daniels.
Got a good one, right?
Right on. Well, God bless you, Farmer Ryan. Hope your family is okay, and man, thank farmers, absolutely. You're the best. Joe, welcome to the Hammer and Nigel show. Joe, what do you want to talk about?
Hey, guys. First of all, prayers for Farmer Ryan and his son, for sure. A couple weeks ago, you guys were talking about vanity license plates, so I want to comment on that. But first, I just love listening to you guys, because listening to you guys being such knuckleheads just gives me hope that a guy like me can maybe someday be rich and successful like you guys are.
I don't know about either one of those words to describe us, but okay, I'll take it.
I think you just got community noted live on the air.
Thank you.
On the license plate, I sent this in on Facebook Messenger, but I don't know if you guys saw it. But up here in Fishers a couple years ago, I saw a Ferrari that was probably worth north of $150,000, maybe $200,000. Right. Had the best vanity license plate ever. It just said 2.5 GPA on it.
Nice.
So maybe indicating that he's not like the smartest guy in the world or didn't do well in high school, but you could still make it out there.
Hey, right? Just like you guys, there's room for low achievers, yeah. Right?
That's right, man.
I think I had about a 2.5. I'd be lucky if I had a 2.5 in high school. And hell, I never graduated college.
There's a plaque hanging up in the Ball State Communications Wing named after David Letterman.
Oh, that's right.
And the plaque says, this is dedicated to all the C students
yes.
before and after me.
Yes.
So
good
the
call.
Dream is alive. Jay, welcome to the Hammer and Nigel show. Jay, what do you want to talk about?
Hey, guys. I'm a five-year ISU grad, or I was on the five-year plan at ISU. Married in the IU season basketball tickets and was at senior day. I need cheered up this week.
We're doing our best.
Now, hey, listen, here's what you need to know about this current condition of basketball in the state of Indiana. Indiana State did not get screwed, and according to Mike Wilson, he's done his job. And Purdue, though, they're a number one seed, so they got that going for them.
Yeah, fear the peacock.
There you go. Drake, welcome to the Hammer and Nigel show. Drake, how are you?
Five words for you, fellas. Hammer and Nigel Beer Festival. Woo! Speaking into existence, fellas. Let's do it.
I love Drake. Is this our Drake? Is this the Drake we know and love?
Drake for America.
Drake for America. Hammer and Nigel Beer Fest? Are you kidding me?
It'll be bigger than Strawberry Festival on Monument Circle. It'll be so huge, I swear.
It sounds like a good idea.
Why haven't we thought about that?
Because we know what would happen. Like, afterwards, our boss, Dion, the head guy of Urban One, is going to bring us into an office. Five people died of alcohol poisoning at your beer festival. They're all suing you now. We're going to have to let you go.
Let me tell you something. Dion would love that idea.
He would.
If we could make it happen.
Absolutely.
That's like our boss's boss's boss.
Now, our legal department's head is spinning around, but Dion would absolutely be on board for that. Drake, you are the best. All right, here's what I'm going to do right now. Allison, clear the lines, okay? Get rid of everybody right now. And let's take a whole new round of people that want to win Kenny Chesney tickets. Callers number 9 and 10, you get the opportunity to play the new and improved Kenny, Benny, or Denny game for your chance to win tickets to go see Kenny Chesney.
Well, it didn't work out. It didn't work out so well yesterday.
I made a tweak.
Okay.
I made a change in the game. Okay. So if you feel like you can know the difference between Kenny, Benny, or Denny, caller number 9 and 10, 239-9393, your chances to win next.
Have you saved enough? Do you have a plan for Social Security and taxes in retirement? Hey, Casey Weed of Howard Bailey Financial, where our mission is to help you gain clarity and purpose and elevate meaning in your life through personal and practical financial strategies. Financial peace of mind means knowing you've covered all of your bases. And for retirement, that begins with building a solid foundation. That's why we want to give you our Retire with Purpose Toolkit at no cost. In it, you'll find valuable information on minimizing taxes, maximizing Social Security, and building a retirement income you can't outlive. Plus, you'll receive a copy of my book, Job Optional. To get your complimentary toolkit, call or text the keyword info 42 to 866-482-9559. That's info 42 to 866-482-9559.
Investment advisory services may be offered through Howard Bailey Securities, LLC, a registered investment advisor. Working with Howard Bailey Securities, LLC cannot guarantee investment success or that specific financial goals will be achieved.
Congresswoman Sparks will be ready for your interview soon.
It seems pretty intense in there.
Yeah, kind of crazy. Maybe I'll take some time before the interview to Google Victoria Sparks and learn a little more about her. Whoa, have you seen this article?
One aide calling the lawmaker's workplace behavior manic?
Victoria Sparks was number one on Legistorm's list of worst bosses based on high turnover rates.
Says she, quote, avoided firing aides and instead bullied them until they left.
And the story is based on interviews with half a dozen former staffers.
Yikes. Sparks called staff morons and idiots.
I get this. Victoria Spart says her working style is, quote, not for everyone.
Well, it's not for me. I think I'll pass on this interview.
I'm Chuck Goodrich.
I'm running for Congress. And I approve this message.
Paid for by Go With Chuck Goodrich Committee.
Nobody cares for you like family. Family heating and air.
Hey, this is Malia. We often get asked, when is the best time to buy? And the answer is today, not tomorrow. With rising utility costs, rising product costs, and missed opportunity costs, which you could be saving with a high-efficiency system. Give us a call today to schedule your free in-depth estimate, 317-577-8077.
Family Heating and Air is your trusted local independent American Standard heating and air conditioning dealer.
Plumbing problems stink. The L.D. Smith Crew can handle anything. Call today for $50 off any plumbing repair, big or small.
L.D. Smith Plumbing.
A dirty, stinking honest.
Why are people saying, Hugh, yeah, to Jackson Hewitt? Find out before it's too late. Hurry into Jackson Hewitt today.
Indy's leader in patio installation is now offering a new driveway package. Schedule a free estimate today at IndyDecorativeConcrete.com. That's IndyDecorativeConcrete.com.
All right, multiple chances for Kenny Chesney tickets coming up right after Matt Baer gets us an update on the roads.
All right, Hammer, towards downtown, southbound 65, stop traffic now. After 38th Kessler down to the White River, a little bit beyond, you get a break until you hit 21st Street, and then you will be slow to Meridian Penn. Eastbound 70, slow to downtown. From Harding Street to Meridian, Illinois. Hendricks County, big delay here of about 5.5 miles. It's westbound 70. If you pass State Road 267, that exit, you will be in it. And it runs, again, about 5.5 miles because of road construction that goes on until tomorrow night. Traffic sponsored by Drexel Interiors. Go where the pros go. Drexel Interiors for Timberlake Kitchen and Bath Cabinets. Visit Drexel's Design Centers at 146th Street and River Road or on North Shadeland. Online at DrexelIN.com. I'm Matt Baer. Follow us for instant traffic updates at WIBC Traffic.
54 at the American Standard Heating Weather Center. And let's try it again. Let's play Kenny, Benny, or Denny.
You're listening to the Hammer and Nigel Show.
How does it work, Hammer?
So this is a slightly modified version because yesterday's was a bit of a train wreck. Caller number 9, which happened to be Bradford, joins us. Bradford, how are you?
I'm doing wonderful.
Good. This is how we're going to play the revised game. I'm going to give you a fact about someone. It will either be a fact about country music superstar Kenny Chesney, dead British comedian Benny Hill, or Denny Smith from the Home and Garden Show here at WIBC. You get 2 out of 3, we're going to give you the tickets, okay?
I like it. Let's make it happen.
Here we go. Number 1, Kenny, Benny, or Denny is a host on the Home and Garden Show.
Well, I'm pretty sure that one is Denny.
Yes. There we go.
Easy enough.
Now keep in mind, yesterday's caller got the first one too. Kenny.
Hi, this is Denny Smith. Hi.
Kenny, Benny, Hi. Or Denny was once married to Renee Zellweger.
Well, I actually might have known about this for a long time, but that would be Kenny Chesney.
There you go! Woo! There we go!
Bradford.
My man! See, that wasn't so hard. Bradford, my man.
Who are you going to take with you to the concert?
Well, I'm pretty sure my wife will insist upon going with me.
All right, she has to drive those since you did all the work, okay?
I agree.
Yep.
All right, Bradford, stay on the line, okay? Now, we've got another caller. Caller number 10 standing by since we didn't have a winner yesterday. Todd joins us.
Todd,
how are you?
Todd.
I'm doing great, and I got a favor to ask, and I have the same questions as the other, number 9.
You won't need them.
I really don't think you're going to need them. Like, let's not lower the bar to Biden standards around here where we have to go easier than that.
All right.
All right, here we go. Get 2 out of 3. We're going to give you the tickets. Kenny, Benny, or Denny will text me every once in a while during the show.
That'd be Denny.
Yes, that is correct.
Hi, Denny Smith. Remind Nigel that his dad's birthday is today. Hi. Denny Smith.
All right. One more, and we're going to throw a party, and we're going to give Todd the tickets here. Kenny, Benny, or Denny is a dead British comedian.
That'd be Benny Hill.
No, no, yes! No. One more time, baby. Play that damn song. That's how you win a contest. Woo! I'm jacked up.
I'm Denny Smith.
Holly,
Holly, Holly.
Todd, who are you going to take to the show?
Well, that'd be my wife, Lori.
Okay, your beautiful wife, Lori, she has to drive. Because, again, you won the tickets. You get to get the cocktails and the beverages at the show, okay?
That sounds fair.
Right on. Stay on the line. Allison will take care of you. And we will have one more chance for Kenny Chesney tickets tomorrow on this show.
Yes.
Tomorrow, we are loaded up because not only will we have my gambling degenerate friends on to give us some March Madness bets to make, hearing rumors that the coupon lady is going to join us.
Really?
If you need some snacks for March Madness viewing, the coupon lady is going to have you covered.
We haven't talked to her for a while.
It's been a little bit.
That's your wife?
She joined us a couple weeks ago. You were on vacation. I think Jerry was here. And Jerry did one of her deals. And he kept texting me all weekend. You would have thought this guy won the lottery.
Really?
Yeah, Spanglish was like, I can't believe I got all these 12 packs for this price.
I'm telling you, it was a popular segment back in the day.
So she is going to give you some March Madness savings, some snacks for the viewing of the games. That's coming up tomorrow. But as for today, don't go anywhere, Skippy. We've got one more hour to go. Don't go anywhere. We're going to check in with Joe Biden and talk about some of the attack ads that he's choosing to run. That's coming up next. This is the Hammer and Nigel Show.
Business. It's not a 9-to-5 proposition. It's all day and into the night. It's all the things that keep this world turning. And behind